Hello, 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 everyone. Just kind of getting set up here, so got a little background ambiance, but no music. I gotta get some music going in the stream like Rob does. Some of the other guys, so I need to start doing that, but right now I'm just kind of getting set up. So if you want to hang out, we got about a half hour to start time. So anybody in chat, thanks for joining. Just kind of making sure all the sounds work and getting things rolling, so you might hear me playing a few miscellaneous sounds. And if you guys hear those in the stream and they're too soft or too loud, let me know. Right now you should hear a little bit of a kind of a fire cracking ambiance. Maybe I'll do a town. I love some of these, by the way. How about we do a medieval town? This is from Tabletop Audio. Pretty cool stuff. So if anybody does jump into chat and hears the sounds, give me a little, type me a little something on how they sound to you, too soft, too loud, or just right. A little Goldilocks there for me. I would appreciate it. Hope everybody's doing well tonight. I'm excited. We missed last week, and they just are finishing out Riverguard Keep, but they just got rid of Jolliver. They got a few other baddies possibly to fight in the area they're in the keep, in the immediate area they're in, and then we'll see about the rest of the keep. So it'll be interesting. God, this layer thing always throws me off. I like it, but then again, sometimes it can be a challenge. Just trying to figure out who's on what layer, where the token's at, all that fun stuff. But there's some good things as well. So they came in here under cover of darkness. So we'll see where they go from here. Prince of the Apocalypse, I really like it. But boy, is it it's challenging to prepare for because it's so large. So open, I should say. Open and large. Stream doesn't look that good on my iPad. I'm trying to figure out why chat's not looking so good. That's why you see me staring down at my iPad. Oh, no, you don't, because I don't have the stream on yet. Just have the coming soon slide. Streaming in. Yeah, that looks good. Take off this background. Maybe just had too much going on. Just looks like it's buffering. I'm gonna type in here and see if it's working. Yeah, it doesn't look like that's working. That's troubling. I'll get out of it and come back in. It's probably my iPad. Whenever I seem to have problems, it's usually just the iPad. Not caught up to something or what have you. So let's see. Yeah, that looks better, I think. There we go. Just had to reboot and come back in. Yep. Looks like it's in there. I see you in there, Urash. How are you doing tonight? Just getting ready. Prepping. Taking a look at where we are. We took last week off, so. I'm looking forward to our game on Sunday, Urash. That's going to be a good time. I think we got a number of new players, and it should be a fun little adventure. And I'm sure you can jump right in and help me teach the folks about Fantasy Grounds. It'll be a good, hopefully a good session. Oh, I gotta take some of this off. You know, I hate it when I start playing around between games and realize I put on effects that I didn't mean to. Like Bardic Inspiration when we don't have a bard. I was testing some things out there. There's another one. It's too funny. Let's see, I think the rest are good. Frenzy. Oh, there's another Bardic Inspiration. So when does Frenzy go away? And he's going to be exhausted, isn't he? Raged. Yep, it is. Certainly is one level of exhaustion, which will mean disadvantage on ability checks. Or actually, I think any checks, if I remember right. Let's take a look at Rob's exhaustion one table. Yep, there we go. So let's see if that lasts any longer. Bar, 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 bar. So it's when the rage ends, and the rage should end right now because they just finished. Yeah. Lasts for 1 minute, ends early if you're not conscious or your attack ends and you have all that good stuff. So I think that is going to end. So let's see, I'm looking something up real quick. Yeah, that's right. That makes sense. A turn is 6 seconds. Then. Oh, that's right. It's around. That's right. Around to six seconds. That's right. So we've been going about a minute. He's probably. So if they've done 4 rounds, so it's 24 seconds. So yeah, this has all happened pretty quickly. They can decide what they want to do. And they should be joining shortly. Hopefully. Oh. I'm responding to somebody who is private messaging me in Discord, so. Alright. So what do we got going here? Who's... Oh, it's showing my stream go live. That's good. Should already have me as, Yeah, it should be... Should already show that I'm live, so that's good. That makes sense. 23 minutes. Hopefully everyone's reasonably on time. I think they will be. What else can I play? How about a yay from Sirenscape? Yay! Love Sirenscape. And again, Urash, I don't know if you're in there or just kind of hanging in an AFK, but let me know how this sounds. I think I've got them dialed in pretty well, but if it's too loud, too soft, just let me know. And I hope you guys can hear everything. Background music. Little dogs barking. Horses. And that, again, is tabletop audio, which I love, too, for the ambiance. I got to do more with Sirenscape in terms of the custom sounds and creating my own sounds. Done a lot with what they have and worked with Rob. And, of course, Rob's done the majority of the work. But putting together the chat sounds, which you guys will hear tonight, I love the fact that we have all those chat sounds going and connected. It's awesome. Did I change these to Pogs? No, I didn't. I was thinking about changing the characters to Pogs, but I didn't do that yet. That's alright. See if they're going to get their beast companion of the ranger. Poor thing is sitting outside the walls. See if they remember. And hide a little bit more of this map down here. Ah, dang it. I hate when I do that. Grab the whole flipping map. That won't be the first time tonight. Or it is the first time. I take it back, but it won't be the last. There we go. That's the thing about the layers, is you always got to remember if you're on the right layer, and then if you are on the right layer, are you on the mask mode? A lot of stuff to think about, guys. A lot of stuff to think about. But it's all good. It is all good. Where's my other map here? Second floor. Overlay. Good. There we go. Damn dog barking in the background. Won't hear it on Discord, but you might hear it in the stream. Hopefully not. Lab must see something out there. So what time is it? It is the middle of the night, so let's see if I can do a little mood lighting for you in here. So when you guys, when I do connect, turn on the stream, you'll see a little mood lighting, hopefully. Excellent. You know, that, are we there? Okay, there we go. In the evening, and I kind of did a little Excel spreadsheet. So there's a mood lighting extension that allows you to kind of change what things look like, you know, the flavor of the screen. Not all of them. Some of them are just text, but you have like a day, which obviously is bright. You've got a middle of the night, which I'm putting up on the stream. When I click over, you'll see that. And you've got, like, sunrise, things like that. It's pretty cool. I enjoy it. And I keep a little Excel timesheet that helps me keep track of the time. I do it in basically three-hour increments, so there's only 8 sections. Sunrise, kind of mid-morning, midday, afternoon, dusk, evening, late evening, middle of the night. So it's kind of helps me, so at least I know when they've taken a long rest and don't let them get too comfortable with long and short rests. So they're actually getting close to level 5. They might, by the end of this session, they've only got about 700 experience points, a little less than that, to get to level 5. So they're going to be kind of excited, because I think a lot of them will unlock their second attacks and things like that. So I think they'll be excited. And it'll get them to where, if they get to this next section, this might be a little hairy. If they go underneath and go into the river and the underneath the keep, as you guys probably know, if they start heading towards the temple of the crushing wave, they're going to be a little bit too, their level's going to be too low, that's what I'm trying to say. Only at the 4th level. 5th level will help. 18 minutes. Let's see who's in Discord. Anybody in Discord trying to message me? I know Rob and some of those guys hang out. I need to start creating a little bit more in my Discord chats, but since I get up at 4:30 in the morning, it's kind of hard. After we're done, I usually shut down pretty quickly and head off to bed. Some of these guys stay in and chat about the game after, which I think is pretty cool. I did create a music channel in my Discord. I'm still playing around with the right things. Oh, Rosh, I didn't set it up. Prater has that in his channel, and I don't know if Rob does, but I probably should have set something up for President's Day Con. I think all the sessions are almost full now. It's going to be fun. I think we've got another session I'm in with Rob tomorrow night's full. My fifth level adventure, The Dead from Above, it's going to be run over two sessions, Saturday afternoon and Sunday, and of course I'll stream those. And that's full. And then the game that you're playing in, Greenskin Diplomacy, on Sunday afternoon, that's full. So, and I think Rob's games, I think GeoQuester's games are filling up, High Jumpers, Praetor's. It's pretty neat to see all those games getting full. Tell you, it was kind of a last minute. I was in Rob's channel. You might have been in that game when I just decided, you know what, it'd be fun to get a bunch of people together for President's Day. And next thing you know, I'm creating a website using event software. I'm trying to figure out the best way to promote it, and it kind of took off. In fact, I'm going to look right now while I'm waiting for the team, see what's still open. So, dashboard, game sessions. So it looks like, yeah, there's still a little bit of openings for, there's one, at least one, maybe two openings for a Sunday afternoon with High Jumper, Pray for Smiley Bob. There's some Delver's Society stuff with GeoQuester that still has some availability, but looks like it's filling up. The Dead from Above, like I said, my game is full. Praetor's Rejects is running a game that he's got three players in Saturday night, excuse me. Delver Society Saturday early AM, that's pretty open. Praetor's Friday night game is getting filled up. He's already got four. GeoQuester's Friday night's full, and Rob's session that I'm playing in is full, so it's a good slate. You know what? I wonder if I can do something while I'm waiting. Let's do this. Upcoming game sessions. Can I just go to the website? This is my account. If I can just get to the main page, I might just throw that out to people. How about let's do that? See if I can throw this into DeepBot while I'm waiting. PDCon. Off. Then let's do that. So add new, save. Then let's go back. How do I do that? God, it's been a while since I've done this. POT players, PO. Oh, I should have changed that. Let's change this. Well, that might work. Let's see. But I want to do the event messages, the timed messages. Oh, so that's what I should have done. Let's do that. Okay, and now I go back to this, channel commands, and add new. shoved it over there, which I didn't want, but here we go. PDCCon. Or PDCon. PDCon. Message. Click this link to find 5e game this weekend with many great GMs. I always call them DMs, but I really like to call them DMs, so let's see if I can do that. Can I do... And see if that works. Come on. Boom. Put that in. Save. Save and close. Now, Urash, if you can hear me, if you're still in there, go ahead and type that exclamation point PDCon. See if it works now. And I'm going to put a timed message. Do I have the messages? They're not popping up. Message every... Oh, that's because there's not enough. I don't need to do the... I don't want the minimum lines. So maybe these ones are enabled. But I think that's because I might have set the minimum chat. Edit. Can I do that again? Edit. Edit. It's just the actions. I don't want the 50. Oh, guys are starting to come in. Hopefully it doesn't affect them. They're on a different connection than I am. All right, let's try this again. Let's do this every 10 minutes and enable it. And I'm going to try to... Actually, can't I just do this now? Run now. There we go. See if that works now. Just run it now. Oh, wait. Why didn't that? Ah, darn it. Can't I put a link in there? It's not letting me do that. Why isn't it letting me do that? Well, not let me do that? Should let me do it. Shoot! I've done that before. HTTP. That works. Maybe I just have the link wrong. Let's try this again.
Liking the goat sounds.
Hey, what's going on, Noah? Trying to fix something that's not working, so give me a second. Ah. Well, I hate it when it doesn't work. Let's try this again. Yeah, I'm trying to create a link that's not letting me. Is Jason on yet? And Cole? There we go. All right. So how are you doing tonight?
Who, me?
You. Yep.
I'm doing all right. Battling a cold, but I'll live.
Ah, man. I did notice if we get into anything that's funky, when you guys connected, it told me you're all running on a prior version. You guys aren't on the most recent
of
Fantasy Grounds.
Really? I just updated it.
Yeah, you guys are all, it looks like, let's see, it looks like you guys are on 3.2.2.
How can I check that?
I don't know. Once you're logged in, I'm not sure how to do that. So we can look at it later. It says that the host is on 3.2.3 and you guys are on 3.2.2.
How interesting, because when I pulled up Fantasy Grounds, it asked me to update, and I did.
And really? Well, we'll see.
Okay.
Yeah, and if it runs has a problem. Now, do me a favor. If you open either Flervin or Darvik, if you double-click on the token on the top right. I'm just curious. Yeah, that pulls up the map. Good.
Oh, nice.
Now, do you see health bars?
I do not.
For on anybody? Sorry? So you don't see them on anyone? I'm sorry.
No, not on anyone.
Okay, I didn't know. So let me try one thing. I'm going to try Flervin. Keep your eye on Flervin.
Okay. Up, there it is.
That's interesting.
What did you do?
Well, I'd heard a tip on the forum that if I just change the status, like change your hit points and then change them right back, it just doesn't sync sometimes. Can you see bar bars now? Okay, good. Yep.
There's the Marcos.
Yeah, I guess it's a little easier than doing this than taking you guys off and putting you back on.
Yep, that's everyone.
Yeah, the only one you might not see because she's off the screen is Nebula.
Right.
Cool. Well, hopefully that should work now. Well, I'm going to go live, guys, a little bit early, just waiting for the rest of them to come on. I always like that one. That never gets old.
That's a good one.
And remember, you guys can change it, sound and all that good stuff.
In terms of...
Uh-oh. Am I back?
You are now. Yeah, I heard you drop off there.
Yeah, hold on 1 second. Okay, I'm going to try this one more time. Okay, good.
Yeah.
Good. Yeah, I mean, it gets so confusing because I've got three versions of Discord open, so I always have to be careful which one I'm clicking on.
Okay, right. Now, what was this you were saying about changing the sounds?
Changing sounds. Now I don't even... Oh, I just meant if the sounds are too loud, don't forget you can right-click on in Discord, and you can turn them up and down. Like if
remember that thing we were telling you about with the metallic sound, and then you were gone for a few seconds. That just happened.
No.
Yeah, I missed most of what you said.
Crap. I mean, is it bad now, or is it?
No, okay? I can hear you perfectly now. It just went metallic-y. I lost you for about three and a half seconds, and then you came back.
All right. I was just saying you can right-click in Discord on the Gwydion Sounds or Gwydion WMP and turn the volume up or down if you need to.
Ah, yes. Right.
Yeah, it looked like it might have been an internet thing, because I think my voice connected, dropped for a second way down, and then came back.
Okay.
I don't know.
I see we have Demacos and Enna with us.
Yo. Yeah. You guys hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Okay.
Hello?
Yeah,
hello.
We can hear you too.
Sweet.
Now, I was telling Noah that it looked like when you guys all connected, you guys were on a different version. You're on a prior version of Fantasy Grounds. At least that's what mine says.
Yeah, I saw the update. I just didn't hear anything about if we should update or not.
Okay, so I think it's fine. I didn't realize that I had done one since the last time we played, so I don't think it'll make a difference.
Well, see, and that's weird. I was telling Alan, it said that there was an update, so I went ahead and updated. But he's saying it's still showing me as being on the older version.
That's weird.
Yeah, it is strange. Well, we'll just plow forward and we'll see. I don't think it's going to affect anything. So do you guys? So do you see the health bars? I just kind of did something to fix them.
I don't see a map.
Oh, yeah, sorry. So guys, open up your character sheet, any of them, and then double click on the token in the top right.
Aha! Yeah, I see health bars.
Okay. And Enna, do you see health bars?
Yes.
Okay, cool. Yeah, somebody gave me a tip that if I change the status, like if I change your wounds from 10 to 9 or whatever, it'll somehow like sync your token, and that's all I did. So it looks like that worked for everybody.
Cool.
So, all right, awesome. So just a quick recap. So we missed last week because of me. So basically where we left is you guys just finished. Oh, thanks for the follow. Is that Voodoo? Thank you for the follow, man. We had just finished. You guys had battled Jolliver, good old Jolliver, the were-rat, and a couple of his cronies. So you had scaled the wall, and you'd made it in undetected. So you guys made it in very quietly. You battled in here, and literally the battle just ended when we stopped our session. So you guys can look at where you are in terms of hit points. I think you had gotten some chat heals. I remember Enna getting some heals. So you guys aren't too far down in terms of your hit points. But if you haven't already, you might want to take a look at your spells and things like that to see if there's anything else you want to do. And it's about 2 o'clock in the morning, because you guys came in the dead of night. So there's a couple doors on this lower level, which is the map you have. And if you remember, there's another map that I can show you in a bit that is the upper. So the stairs that go up, like, I think, Darvik, you might be on the upper level, if I remember right.
That makes sense, yeah.
So, I mean, we can kind of figure out where you guys want to go, and then we can open one of the two maps. But essentially, the stairs go up to a second level, and then there's also, on the lower level, there's a door to the kind of the northwest and the southwest that you can see.
Now, if I remember right, last time when Darvik went up there, he gained a line of sight down the hallway up at the top of the stairs.
He did.
Yeah. That's currently not revealed on the, at least on my map.
Well, and I just shared another map with you, but it's because
that's the one.
There's two maps. Yeah. That's the issue is, so I kind of have mine side by side. I have the upper floor on the right side of my screen, and I've got the lower floor on the left. So it's just a little bit challenging, but you're right. So,
sure.
So anyway, you guys right now, I kind of have you all, your tokens are essentially all on the lower level, but, you know, you guys can kind of chat with what you want to do, and we can start from there. Don't forget, and it's only been, I don't know, 30, 40, you know, probably about a minute since you got in here. Nebula is still outside, so not that you need to do anything with that now, but don't forget that she's outside the wall. She couldn't scramble up the pythons that you guys stuck into the wall.
Oh, yeah. I remember that now. Thanks.
No, there was a lot going on. So and also, if you guys want to open up the party sheet very quickly, which is, again, that little eye with the three people, you're getting pretty close to fifth level.
Sweet.
So, yeah, it looks like you've got... Well, actually, I thought it was even closer. Maybe it is 6,500. So, yeah, you guys got about 1,200 left. For some reason, I thought you were even closer, but that looks right.
I think it only shows on your party sheet. I don't
see. Oh, okay. If you open your character sheet, that's probably... Right. Well, I mean, can you look at the XP tab of the party sheet, Noah?
No. There's not an XP tab.
Okay, got it. So, yeah, if you look on your character sheet, and you click on the magnifying glass, that's where it'll show is if you've put in the next level, which I think you guys all did.
Yeah, it looks like another 1,200 or so, and we're there.
Nice.
So cool. So that's, you know, quick and dirty recap, but to jump right in, but tell me, you know, what you guys are thinking and what you want to do. So again, it's kind of middle of the night. You just had a nice little battle. It's pretty challenging, and you're still in the middle of Riverguard Keep.
Now, I don't remember Demacos having Mage Hand on, but he apparently does.
You know what? I'm trying to think if you would. You might have done that to open the door initially. I don't remember, to be honest. Because you have it. I mean, you can certainly take it off if you don't need it or you don't think it was on there. You can. I think.
Well, I mean, it's not hurting anything, so.
And then what do we need to do about Barbar's rage and frenzy?
Yeah, his frenzy is going to bring him to a level of exhaustion down, if I remember right.
Yeah, I mean, in rage, you know, I would say it's just about ending right now, and given you guys aren't in combat, is going to wear off, and then I'll put on a level of exhaustion, because you would have one level, if I remember correctly.
Yeah. I still have two rage available with him. Okay. Before taking a rest, but I'll have that level of exhaustion until we do take a rest.
Okay, so let me do that.
I'm not sure if it's a long or short. Let me take a quick look. I think it's short.
I wonder if I put the mage hand on you, because I was doing a little bit of testing things out earlier in the week, but yeah, I don't remember. But you have the spell, so it's possible you had it on you.
Yeah,
I think I would have had a token, though, because I think I have a Mage Hand token.
Yeah, I've never seen it before.
So, well, let me go ahead and for Barbar, let me take off, unless there's anything. I mean, I'm going to go ahead and take off those and then apply the effect. Oh, you know what? You guys might see, I thought I took this off. You might see a little, well, you might not. Never mind. If you see anything weird, like a little guy that has a, it's like blue and red next to any of your effects, let me know, because that's an extension that probably shouldn't be loaded.
No, I do see one next to Mage Hand. There's a guy with, looks like, well, like a red slash to it.
Now, that's okay, because that's an effect that basically allows you to remove it as a player that I created, so you can take it off if you need to.
Cool. Okay.
All right, so let me apply the... real quickly, if I can find it. Oh, that's right. It's in Rob's table. One sec.
Let's see. Yeah, long rest will reduce a creature's exhaustion level by one. So yeah, we'll have to do a long rest before that goes away.
I guess we didn't have an effect. I'm going to have to ask Rob about that. I didn't hear anything for exhaustion.
Oh, sound effect? Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't hear it either.
Yeah, probably just not gotten to it yet, maybe. I hope. Yep, I don't see it.
And I forget, what are the effects of exhaustion?
It's basically, if I remember right, you have disadvantage on most of your checks, your ability checks. And
Yeah, it says Level 1 exhaustion, the effect is disadvantage on ability checks, according to the table in Appendix A.
That sounds right.
Hard book, yeah.
So yeah, if you end up rolling for stealth checks or strength checks or whatever, and you see it, you'll see it, or see that, that's why. Hey Rob, so snap your table.
Combat so much, but you know, if I had to bust down a door or something, it's gonna be a disadvantage.
Yeah, I love POTA too, Rob, because I watched you DM it so much.
I don't know if that would be, does that affect combat?
The level 1 exhaustion.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, if there's any ability checks you need to make, I don't think it's going to apply on saving throws, but I'm not positive. And if it does, then it certainly could affect you. But otherwise, you know, it'd be initiative, it'd be a dexterity check or, a strength check, things like that.
Yeah, it looks like once you hit level 3 exhaustion, you get your disadvantage on attack rolls and saving throws.
Okay, so that is the saving. Okay, I've actually never seen anybody get to 3, so that makes sense, though.
Yeah, let's try not to do that one.
Yeah, and then I think, what is it, 5th or 6th is death. So don't go that far.
Slow down, Barmar.
Exactly.
Okay.
Okay, so we definitely need to get a long rest going. And both my guys are just not out of spells.
Yeah, Democus' slots are spent.
Cool, Rob.
Question is, I'm guessing we can't take a long rest in here since it's enemy territory.
Yeah, sure, we could try.
You could try. I mean, you snuck in the dead of night, and it's 2:00 in the morning. You can certainly try to take a long rest.
Well, we had an enormous battle, and some people, as I recall, crashed in through the main doors because they heard the scuffle.
That's right. Sure, that's right. They did, didn't they?
So I don't think we went undetected.
So without spell slots for Darvik and Flurvin, are there useful cantrips that you have access to?
Question is how you define useful.
Well, they got guidance and spare the dying. You could save
you. There's some stuff in, I mean, Darvik does have sacred flame and there is firebolt. So yeah, I mean, they're useful, but they're not powerful.
Yeah. Well,
should we explore the lower and upper parts here and see if we can at least verify that it's cleared out?
Yeah, because I mean, if it's cleared out, we could try to barricade ourselves in a room, set some hunting traps, and hope for the best.
Yeah, and I have cure wounds. I have 3 slots open if we need it.
Oh my. Good. Well, that's helpful.
All right, so should we go up first or down first?
Let's see here.
I don't know if you guys can hear it in the ambiance, Rob. I've got a little
you guys wanna go
tabletop
up?
Audio going on in the background.
Doesn't really matter one way or the other.
Yeah, it doesn't.
All right. It is.
Let's go up.
Little
up and away.
All right, so give me a second. All right. Yeah, you guys can do that.
What the hell, Barbar?
Now, let's see. If I lock tokens, it should be the same as last time, so I think I have.
Yeah, they're locked.
I'm trying to wait longer to actually do your move until I make sure that you guys are done. I have a tendency to, as soon as I see it stop, I'll just approve it. Beyonce, that's right, Rob. Beyonce. Okay, so now that you guys are there, let me pull up the other map. Give me 1 second. Did that work? Can you guys see it?
Yeah.
Yep.
That's awesome. Okay, good. That's sweet. I love it.
Yeah, Barbara, I know you're tired, but it'd be helpful if you went first.
All right.
All right, sorry. I was just getting my map situated over here.
Oh, I don't think we're locked again.
It's probably a new map, so give me a sec.
Okay.
Yep, there you go.
Just finally putting a tab on the player's handbook for barbarians. I don't have to keep thumbing through trying to find it.
Oh, gotcha.
All right, guys. Top to bottom, any preferences?
Talk about a loaded question.
How about evens up, odds down? Yeah. Looks like we're heading down. Should we have Enna come check the door for traps?
Hey guys, I'm sorry. Something just came up. I'm going to have to leave for a few minutes. I'll be back.
No problem. Okay. We'll play. Yep. Sounds good. Okay.
I can check the traps.
So is Barbara just kind of getting out of the way?
Yeah. Making room.
Okay, so go ahead, Enna, and roll me a perception check in the tower. Okay, stand by 1 second. Yeah, 1 sec. And it's at the bottom you're looking at, correct?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. So you don't hear anything in the room.
Okay. So no traps, and is the door locked?
Oh, sorry. You do not see any traps, and you also don't hear anything.
Okay.
What about locked?
Are you checking to see if it's locked?
Yeah, that was also one of my checks.
Okay, it is not locked.
Okay. I'll move out of the way so Barbara can do his thing.
Okay.
Hopefully poor Nebula has a owner coming back soon. Maybe we don't.
Yeah, we forgot to leave her food.
she's probably out hunting. All right, how are we doing it? Are we just barging in? We open it up, or we tell me what we're doing?
Well, you know what? Let me move out of the way again. I think maybe you should, I don't know if whatever you would think it needs to be, stealth or what, but we should probably try to get a peek inside if we can. Barbar's checks are at a disadvantage, so probably better off if he doesn't do it.
Okay, I will peek in quietly.
Okay, roll a stealth check in the tower. Okay, so the door opens, you know, very quietly, and as you peek in, you see four bunk beds that line the walls of this guard room. To the south, you see an arrow slit that looks out over the castle yard, and a door exits to the castle parapet. And then you're coming through another door to the north. So you see all these beds. It looks empty, so you don't see anyone in here at the moment. So let me unmask it.
Oh, it's a narrow little room.
Yeah.
So, yep. So that door to the bottom left is a door that looks out, kind of goes out on the parapet, and then kind of on the bottom right, if I can draw my arrow, that's like an arrow slit.
Okay.
Okay.
Should we go in and search the room?
Yep. As well.
Okay.
Yep. So roll me an investigation check in the tower.
Okay.
Okay, you look around and, you know, it looks like, you know, obviously it looks like the barracks for a number of Reavers, and you guys fought some of the Reavers before, so you kind of have a suspicion that the Reavers that were in here came out to fight you guys earlier. But you don't see anything else, you don't know notice anything else, just clothes and personal items.
Should we take a rest in here?
Well, we probably need to find out if there's anyone on the other side of this door to the south before we attempt that.
The south or north?
Well, probably both, really. If we knew that we were alone in this building, let's see, there's still rooms beneath us, too, though.
Yeah.
We probably need to make sure that we are actually alone in here, and if we are, then I think we could attempt it.
Okay. So, maybe we should roll to see what door we open next?
Yeah. Or we can just go ahead and check this one that you're kind of close to. I know you're by the arrow slit, but...
Okay. I'll move there. I like to check for traps.
Okay. So go ahead and roll a perception check in the tower. So you you do not believe the door is trapped. You like that? You like those choice of words?
Shoot. Mm. Might as well.
Yeah.
Can't stand in here. Nope. Wait.
And is it locked?
Yeah, guys, stand. It is not locked, but stand by 1 second because I'm actually checking something in the book because I think we have a. I think there's an issue with this map. So just.
Okay.
Yeah, there is. Okay, so here's the thing. Just. Give me 1 second, see if I can show you this.
Okay.
So I'm going to create a door stream because there should be a door to Jolliver's residence up there, and there is not. So I'm going to create one just to show them there's a door here. So maybe just kind of do something like this. All right, so I don't have a really cool token to show you, but it's interesting. There should be a door on so directly to the west. That little token I put right on the map. So that's a door as well. So there's a door below. You know, in the room you're in, there's a door to the west, and there's a door above you. But on the map, for some reason, it's not in the in the Fantasy Grounds version. That's interesting. I don't remember seeing that before.
Okay. Well, maybe he's probably still check the door or check the room we're heading towards.
Okay.
So I have to check them all eventually.
Yeah, so another it is not locked. So
I would like to try to quietly peek in.
Okay. Let me open it up a bit. So roll me a stealth check in the tower as you're opening the door. Okay, so as you peek out there, you know, probably about 40, you know, maybe 30, 35 feet away from you. So you can tell this is the top of the wall. So this is kind of where the guards had been patrolling back and forth, and you see a guard that's patrolling on the wall. But he's right now, he's kind of walking the other way.
Probably should go ahead and quietly close that door.
Yeah, I like to quietly close the door.
Okay.
It's probably not the route we want to go just yet.
All right. So you get the door closed without incidents, and he was kind of walking the other way, so he wasn't going to hear you as you did that.
Good. Okay. I'm going to walk out of the room.
Okay.
Should I check the door above me?
Yeah, might as well. Okay. We can get some of this investigative work out of the way before Flurry and Darvik gets back.
Okay. I would like to, again, check for traps on this door and to see if it's locked.
Okay, so go ahead and roll a perception check in the tower. Okay, and you do not believe it's trapped.
Quietly peeking in.
Okay, so as you peek in there, you see old bookshelves that line the walls of this room, but you don't see anything else.
I just lost you.
Okay, can you hear me? Hello?
I can hear you now.
Okay.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, yeah. So you see bookshelves as you kind of crack the door open, but you don't see anything else. So, do you want to go all the way in and I'll open it up, or you tell me what you want to do?
Yes, I like to go all the way in.
Hey guys, I'm back. Sorry about that.
Okay.
No, we're just investigating rooms, so we're still on the top floor. Okay, so you say old bookshelves line the walls of this room, but most are empty. One old shelf has been cleared and restocked with a selection of tomes. A single bunk sits under the narrow window at the far end of the room near a small desk. A wooden chair and a chest. The floor looks wet.
Yeah. Let's see here. Flurvin, Darvik, you see the area that got explored kind of to the south?
Yes.
That is... It leads out to the wall where the guards are patrolling. Uh-huh. And in a stealthily peeked out the door and saw a guard, but he was walking the other way, so we closed the door back.
Good call.
Just to let you know, this the room that Demakos is in was kind of insignificant, just kind of guard bunkery. That's about it so far. Might as well check out this room, though. Go investigate it, at least.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll lock in it.
Arvar is going to get his butt out of the way.
So, and are you, what are you doing? You're just kind of investigating?
Investigate the room.
Okay, do me a favor and roll an investigation check in the tower. Okay, stand by 1 second. So you see a little wooden chest by the bed in here, and you see a bunch of books and the like, and that's all you see.
I would like to try to open the chest.
Okay. And the chest is not locked, so you open the chest, and you see a bunch of silver pieces, gold pieces, and you see a silk pouch with some gems, a scroll, actually two scrolls. So let me give that to you 1 second. I'm going to put it in the party sheet, so you can't identify all of it, all of these scrolls, of course, right now, but let me give that to you.
Enna, do you mind if Flervin comes in? He'd like to have a look around, too.
Yep. Go ahead, I'll move out of the way.
Flervin walks through walls.
I tried to have him go south, and then it just went west. It's weird.
Huh. Okay, so, and then some of this again. Uh-oh. Got a stacking issue. One sec. Was that Enna that was moving to, or?
I was moving to where Flervin just moved to.
Okay, okay. So Flervin, go ahead and roll an investigation check in the tower for me. Okay, so Flervin, as you're on that wall there, you actually kind of push on it, and it feels like the bookshelf itself will kind of push inward. Feels like there's something behind the bookshelf that you're kind of right on that west wall.
Well, would someone other than Gumby Arms like to give it a heave?
Yeah, Barbar can, but he's somewhat Gumbied at the moment. Probably not as bad as Gumby Arms.
Now, I have a spell somewhere. Enhance ability.
Well, guys, just so I'm clear, I mean, you can push it open, but I'm looking for you to tell me if you want to push that open. You can try. I'm just saying right now you can tell that there is something there, and it's you tell me if you want to try to push it open or just what you want to do.
Now, is this the bookshelf that's described as having been cleared and restocked with a selection of tomes?
Yeah, it is. I don't know if it is, but it is now, guys.
Well, Barbara, you want to give it a shot?
Sure. I can lead the way.
Get out of your way here.
Let's see if I actually made it to a square. Nope.
That's right. I'll move you in.
Okay. All right. Well, Barbara's going to give it the old heave-ho.
Okay. You push it, and it kind of feels like it's on a hinge, and it does open and reveals another room. Stand by.
This might be useful for a long rest.
So you see a large semicircular room occupies the western half of the floor. Three narrow windows look out over the courtside outside the castle walls. The room's furnishings are very plain, including a hard-looking bunk, a small wooden table, and a couple of simple chairs. Several large chests occupy the room's southern corner. Excuse me.
My.
Let's check those babies for traps.
And I take it back. I'm glad you guys actually found that, because in the hardcover book of Princes of the Apocalypse, it shows the door. There's a door on this west wall. There shouldn't be. It actually, you guys found the secret entrance, so I'm glad you found it anyway.
So is this the one that you were saying where there should be a door at the end of that hallway?
Yes, and I took the door off because actually in the hardcover book it's there, but now that I read a little bit further, there was a secret entrance in here, so I'm glad you guys discovered it anyway.
Sweet.
All right, so you know, you don't really see him, but over near his bed, near the area you are. You see the, you know, there's a few chests there. So, tell me if you want what you want to do.
Yeah, Barbara's going to see if they're locked.
Okay, and they are not locked.
Enna, do you want to see if they're trapped?
Yeah, I can check if they're trapped.
Uh-oh.
Everybody's moving.
Yeah, I was trying to get out of the way, but I'll just stay where I'm at. Barbar.
All right. So, Enna, go ahead and roll a, I guess, a perception or investigation check in the tower. All right. No, you don't see any traps. You think it's just a normal chests.
Okay.
Let's open them up.
Yeah.
All right. So the lids swing open, and inside you find a bounty of silver pieces, electrum pieces, and some blue azurite. So it looks like this is kind of a. This looks like it was kind of the hoard of probably Grimjaw, Jolliver. This is a pretty big stash here. Stand by 1 second. All right, so now all of those things are in the party sheet. So if you guys want to take a look, I mean, some of it, I guess most of it you can keep in the party sheet. I don't think the scrolls shouldn't be identified for you, are they?
No.
And that's from the previous, but okay, good. So everything else you can kind of see what's in there, and if you want to take anything, you can. But yeah, a lot of silver pieces and electrum pieces.
Yeah, so the only thing that's not unidentified is the feed, the wagon, and the coins.
Good. Well, with the book, some of the other things are... Oh, hold on 1 second. Some of these are pretty obvious, so stand by. I don't know why they did some of these.
Yeah, because I remember you mentioned a few items, but...
Yeah, it's weird that some of them are just pouches and things. I don't know why they would have hid those. Okay. I think that's most everything except for the scrolls.
Cool. Well, you guys want to try to barricade the bookshelf door and attempt a long rest in here?
I think that's a fantabulous idea.
Yes, I think so.
All right. Well, Barbar is, he's going to come up here and close the bookshelf door. How about that first? That'd be a good idea.
Okay.
Swing it back shut behind us.
Out of your way there.
And why did that do that? There we go. And he's gonna set down a hunting trap by the bookshelf door.
Okay.
And if it gets used, I will remove it from inventory.
What does that do? Do you know? I mean, if somebody trips it, do you know what that does?
Yeah, it's okay, so let's see the action. A creature that steps on the plate of the hunter's trap must succeed on a DC 13 dexterity saving throw or take 1d4 piercing damage and stop moving. Thereafter, until the creature breaks free of the trap, its movement is limited by the length of the chain, typically 3 feet long. And it says, creature can use its action to make a DC 13 strength check to free itself. Each failed check deals 1 piercing damage to the trapped creature.
Okay.
So, with that set, our armor is going to move down a little bit.
Okay, 1 second.
If something does get trapped, I want to be more than 3 feet away.
Now, I'm going to suggest that we fan out along the wall so that if something does try and come through the door, we can all make a ranged attack at it.
Yeah, Rob, if they're going to try to do a long rest in here, that they can't get away with that. I'm going to have to throw this at them, so. We'll see how they roll, but I think I'm going to have them. They got to have an encounter if they're trying to do a long rest, even if it's at the end. Oh, PDCon, no worky. Gosh darn it, Rob. I'm sorry. I'll have to check that at a break. All right, so are we doing our normal watch if I pull up the... party sheet?
Yeah, I could do the first two.
Okay. So, Enna, roll me some roll me a d20, two d20s in the tower. If they get a 15 or above, they're gonna get Reesh and his guards, because they'd be looking for Jolliver. Oh, just a straight d20. What did you? I'm not sure what you rolled.
She rolled the 2.
Oh yeah, with the 2.
Okay, because somehow it's giving her. I just meant just pick up the 20-sided die and drop it, because it somehow it's showing like a skill check or something.
I think she just tried to roll both at once.
Oh, I gotcha. Okay, so there's the first one. Can do one more. Okay, and then so who's second watch?
Derek.
That is okay. Correct.
All right, Darvik, give me a d20 in the tower. All right, third. So your watch passes uneventfully. All right, Demakos. And then who do we have last?
Is there only 4 watches?
Oh, you're right. You're right. You're right. That's 4. So, okay. All right. So actually, all right. You guys, just give me 1 second. I'm gonna apply a long rest. So they actually rolled really low, but I'm gonna hit them after this anyway.
Oh, thank goodness.
But I'm gonna hit them right after this. I should have just killed them anyway, Rob.
Sweet.
All right. Oh, then you hear the rest.
That's right. Hear the birds. Chirpy, chirpy. All right. Barbar's going to pick up his hunting trap.
Okay.
Since it did not get spent. We still have the rooms downstairs to explore, too. We haven't done that yet.
Yeah.
And of course, now that it's daytime, we might have company in one of these rooms, too, that we've already explored.
Yes, it is. So let me do that real quickly. All right.
That's cool.
Now, did we search the bodies from the battle that we had?
You have not yet.
Okay, but you already handed out the experience.
I did.
Maybe you ought to go back and do that.
Yeah.
Oh my.
Oh gosh.
And of course, this doesn't let me do the layer thing. God damn it. So, hold on. Why is that not? Stand by 1 second.
Buenos dias.
They're in the wrong spot, but damn it.
Have you made coffee yet?
Cult's coffee is the worst.
That's why I know better than that. And you guys hear a little commotion outside the room. And the door opens.
Oh, shit.
And as the door opens, everyone can roll initiative. Now, hold on. Let's check Barbar. Yeah. So let me take off that.
Still got a 20, though.
All right, I took that off, so you don't have that anymore.
Does he need to re-roll, or is it?
Where are you? No, that's fine. You're already up there, so you're fine.
Okay.
All right. So here we go.
So what, did they hear us snoring or something?
The door is right here. Well, I think they've been kind of out looking for where this group is. Actually, let me show you where everybody is. So they obviously have been looking since Jolliver wasn't around, and you guys have been sleeping for 8 hours. They weren't about to kind of let you guys. They didn't know what was going on, but they certainly saw that Jolliver was missing. So Crushing Wave Reaver with her longsword pulls it out and attacks Barbar. And she hits. Oh my god, and she does. Does he... Was he raging or not? Okay, 6 damage. I thought at first it was a 10. Whew. So, it flipped over. That was good. Alright, and I think that's all she can do. Man, I thought that was max damage for a second. Yep, that's all she can do. So Barbar is up. Buenos dias. I like that, Rob.
Time to rage. Probably not going to kick in frenzy just yet, because I don't want to completely use everything up. Alright.
Okay. He's raging.
Wave Reaver targeted. Yes. Here we go.
Ooh, and you hit. And you do heavy damage. Slices through through her stomach. She's not a happy Crushing Wave Reaver.
Good. Let's see. Okay, there's a wall there. Now, just so I know, is this bookshelf door, is it just above Barbar? Is it like the square up from Barbar?
Yep.
Okay, so if I stay here, they're not going to be able to flank me. Is that true?
Not as they are. That's correct. They'd have to get below you and above you, so right now they can't.
Okay. Okay.
All right, Flurvin. Now, wait. Yeah, okay, that's right. That's all you can do at this point.
We got it in frenzy.
Okay, I think Flurvin's going to go for a chromatic orb on Little Miss Reaver here.
Okay, go for it.
That's what I'm talking about.
Nice.
That's a solid hit. You hit her. Wait for it, guys.
Oh, my. Nice. I killed her.
And, yes, that was an insta-kill there. Nicely done.
Nice.
That'll work.
Pew, pew.
Status, next. Dying. All right, so this guy, what does he do?
Reesh. Reesh reeks. Smells like fish guts.
He's gonna go there and stand by.
Had music for a minute. I thought that drum beat was him walking. I was like, oh shit, he's a big boy.
Probably is a big boy.
Yeah.
All right, so he raises up his hands and he casts a spell. And hold on one second. I don't know why it's not coded. I hate when that happens. Or maybe it is. Hold on.
Oh, not coded. Can't use it.
Yep. So he targets Barbar. And he hits, and you feel, let's see,
ow.
You feel your life force just sucked out of you, like just this wave of dread comes over you as this life force gets sucked out of you.
Necromancer, anyone?
All right, and let's see if there's anything else you can do. Stand by one second. Okay. Then he's going to pass his turn, I believe. Okay, Enna's up.
Okay. Gonna target him.
Okay, and you hit.
Nice.
And you do some damage to him. You catch him in the shoulder.
Okay.
Better than nothing.
Yes, it is.
All right, and this Reaver. Goes here. And uses her sword.
Oh, Barbar.
Swings at Barbar and hits.
Thing is raging.
And does a little damage.
Oh, yeah.
Alright, Darvik's up.
Yeah, Darvik's gonna take a little trot over that way. He's gonna target Barbar and give him a little Cure Wounds love.
Ah, thank you. Oh, nice. That was significant.
Very nice. Love. Very nice use of that spell.
All right.
Darvik's good.
All right, Demakos.
Thank you very much. Hold on a second. I need to mute something here. There we go. Alright. Just getting a bunch of those channel alerts. Okay, here we go. Demakos. Is Darvik in the line of sight there? I can scoot over if need be.
Yeah, I'm gonna let's see. Is who in the line of sight?
Darvik. Like is he in my line of sight to?
No, you can hit Reesh. I need to put an effect. Give me one second.
Okay. Oh my.
Ah.
Okay. Can you guys see that when I'm doing that?
Yeah, yeah. Eric touch.
Yeah, looks darn it. Like. All right, so go ahead.
Okay.
I gotta fix that. So you hit him.
Nice.
Nice hit.
Lucky hit. Oh, look at that minimal damage. Five?
Yes, five. So stand by one second because I need to roll.
I have a feeling I know what's going to happen here.
Okay. All right, so anything else?
Just take a look real quick here. No, I don't think so, actually. There now.
All right, so this Reaver comes here and attacks Barbar.
Now, flank, son of a bitch.
And hits. And she slices into him for 8 points of damage, half of which are resisted.
Can I release Nebula? So she's off the combat tracker?
Yeah. Let me just take her off. One second.
Okay.
So, I'm sorry, Alan. Did you say I got hit for 8 and half was resisted, or did she hit for 16?
Hold on.
Oh, no, never mind. I still had 4 wounds. Sorry.
Yeah, okay. I was going to say, it should only have been 4.
Yep, sorry.
That's right. Go for it, Barbar.
Wake up here. Okay. Alright, I am at this point going to apply Frenzy. Think we could use it. And I'm going to... Oops, not with... Second. There we go.
Okay. And you hit. Oh, put her into critical immediately. Nice hit. Boy, you sliced through her.
Oh, crap. Sorry. I did damage again.
Uh-oh. Bad. Okay, let
that
me...
Was that was 19. Okay. Meant to hit roll again.
Okay. So what was she down to is the question. Damn.
She took 18.
Okay, I got it. Okay.
Okay. I'm going to try to roll for a hit again, since I got Frenzy on.
And you do hit.
Excellent.
And she is down.
Sweet.
Okay, all right, Flurvin.
Target Reesh and let fly 3 Scorching Rays at him.
Nice.
First one hits.
Nice. Thus, the Hothiren!
Nice.
2 more to go.
And the second one hits.
That's it, still. Nice.
Thus, the Hothiren!
Okay.
And number 3.
And it hits.
Sweet.
Thus, the Hothiren!
Nicely done.
All right. Now, hold on. I need to do a few things here. Give me a sec.
I'm just going to heal right back up.
Say? One second.
Hurt, bastard.
Okay, now it's his turn, right? Yep, it's his turn. So he is going to... Second. So let's see, he's going to go ahead and... He's going to attack. Thanks, High Jumper. So he's going to attack Darvik. And he hits. And he does a little light damage. Hold on one second, let me look at something. Okay. So you feel this cold wave go through you as you lose 5 hit points. So, and I think that's all he can do, but I'm checking. Okay, Enna's up.
Okay, I'm gonna try to hit him again.
And you hit.
Nice.
Ooh, very solid. Go slamming into him. Alright, Reaver 6. See, what is she gonna do? She's gonna go there.
Of course she is.
Of course.
Darvik gets a little locked there, doesn't he?
Smart move. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. You got Barbar targeted too. Oh.
Uh-oh.
Take that, Barbar.
So just do me a favor and, yeah, just do it again and untarget him and, yeah.
Sorry about that.
Oh, it's okay.
First I heal, then I hit you.
Okay, and you hit? You hit her?
Big damage.
My damage. All right. All right, so she swings her sword. And misses.
Yes!
At advantage. All right, Darvik.
Darvik needs to stop targeting himself long enough to do something here. Okay, I think it's time for a little inflict wounds action. Or not!
And you still hit.
Oh, that's right, he's got such a low armor class.
He does.
Oh my.
Right in the face!
So that that inflicted the wounds in the face and scarred him not only for life, but in the past life. Very nice. Wow.
Take that with you to the plains. Very nice.
All right, Demakos.
Okay, 5, 15. Just want to make sure I'm not blasting anyone in the face. Other than the, okay, the Reaver here.
And you hit. Too heavy damage.
Sweet! That's only reaction to that. Okay. Get angry, Barbar. Oops. There we go.
And you hit. And she is down.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Let's loot all these ones immediately and see what we can find.
Yeah, and we also forgot to take off a ration.
Oh.
Ah.
Oh, thank you for reminding me. Why don't you guys do that? Because I have to look something up while you're doing that, so stand by.
I think we can just live with Barbar's, whatchamacallit. But we're going to have to. His level of exhaustion after this.
Yeah. Well, it's just been doing ability checks, right?
Yeah.
Well, and I have a spell that'll counteract that if we absolutely need him to do a strength check.
Yeah, it's something mission critical.
Have fun in your game, Rob, if you need to. I know you said you're going to head out soon.
Give him advantage on strength checks so it'll null it out.
Sweet. Nerr. It's kind of funny. Anytime I hear the word null, I see the sequel font.
That's right.
Nice.
I was trying really hard not to make a joke about Azurite in the cloud.
So I'm trying to look at something in Realmworks. Since you guys encountered this guy outside of where you normally would have seen him, so I need to see what he would have had on him, if anything.
Here we go, messing with the order of things.
I know!
See what happens when you drop a freaking goblin vase in a room and for a whatever it was, I forget.
Troll base, yeah.
Troll base.
That's right, I forgot about that. That was pretty cool, though.
I bet no one's done that in the other POTA runs you see on
probably not.
Twitch.
Probably not, because I don't think anybody else would have had that.
That's true. Or carried it with them for that long. And seeing you guys are like, why the heck you carrying it? Mm-hmm. I know it did. It did bite us in the butt at one point, though.
All right, I just got to find where he was, so. See if he had anything on him.
Oh,
Where is Reesh? Where does he? Jeez, man, there's only so many places he can be. Well, I'm just gonna have to make a call for... Oh, well, here we go. I found him. Hold on. Okay, so he does have, kind of wrapped around his waist, he has a leather kind of saddlebag. So that's kind of what you see on him, is just like this kind of basically a saddlebag, kind of like a modern day fanny pack, but in leather.
He's a stylish one in the group, I can tell.
That's right.
He's clearly a child of the 80s.
Alright, well, I guess we should search the Reavers and the fanny pack then.
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay, so as you look at that, at the saddlebag, you see some more gems, you see some 6 agates, you see 70 gold pieces and 12 platinum pieces. Let me give that to you. And you also see a key on him. So give me a second.
Is the fanny pack, like, if I wrap it around my waist twice, will that
be? Sure, you could do it.
I would like to keep it if no one else wants it.
Okay.
Yeah. Fanny pack it up.
Yes.
Okay, it should show up as saddlebag leather if I did that right. And let me undo the agates. And I'm going to have to create this. The key, I don't know why it's not in the parcel, but it does say that he has a key. So one second. You guys should see that key, and do me a favor, I do want somebody to grab the key, because if we ever get in a situation that you guys are split up and does somebody have a key or not, if it's useful. I got burned once for not having somebody grab a key, so go ahead, and whoever wants it can take it, is fine. I just don't want to have it in the general party inventory.
Well, Enna, I think you've been the key keeper, haven't you?
Yeah, I can take the key.
Okay, let me give you the XP.
We have no keys.
Let me give you the XP for that.
And can I try to get at least one of those arrows back? I shot off 2.
So just roll if you remember how to roll a D2, or actually just roll a D4, and if you get a 3 or 4, you get 2 back. 1 or 2, you get 1. So you got them both back.
Yes.
All right. I'm going to make one more note, and then you can tell me where you guys want to go from here.
And where do the coins show up when you put them in?
You should see all the coins. I can distribute them. I think they're on the left-hand side. They should be.
Yeah. It's in the party sheet under inventory, the parcel coins.
Oh, I see. GP's in there twice. I saw a blank GP line, and I thought,
All right.
I tried to grab the key, but I don't think it got on to my inventory equipment tab.
It might show up as just, you might not really be able to identify it, but it should still say, well, no, you're right. Try it again. It should drag right on.
It actually says to the grid in K13.
Oh, excellent. I mean, it's unidentified. Why are you guys seeing that? It's supposed to be unidentified. All right, hold on. Well, I guess it doesn't matter now. You have it. That must be a note that I didn't realize was a public note, but that's fine. You don't know where K13 is.
Nope.
All right.
So, I think Barbar probably needs his level of exhaustion, assuming we're out of combat.
Yeah, you guys are. You guys are. So let me take the rage. Now, do we build it to where you can take the rage off yourself or no?
No. I don't have the little X herd line to the
I'll do that next time.
Okay.
All right.
There it is. Cool. All right, guys. Shall we see what awaits us on our way back towards the downstairs?
Yeah, I want to go loot all the dead bodies downstairs and then go through those two doors.
Well, let's go see if their corpses remain.
All right, so I'm going to take you guys off this map. I'm going to close this one and pull you all down. It'll just be easier, so give me 1 second.
Okay.
Since we have to go down to that other map. And if you guys double click on your tokens in the top right, you should see yourself on the new map as I'm setting this up.
Yep.
So you can put yourselves wherever you want, but you're on the lower level now, so you can kind of decide where to go from there. Yeah, high jumper. I thought I set that up. I'm gonna have to check it on a break. It's not working. I don't know why.
I can't lose my token.
No, me neither.
Probably on the wrong layer. 1 sec.
There we go.
Just trying to get you guys in squares. Okay. All right.
Are the corpses still here? Or are they gone?
The corpses are there, so yeah, you guys can definitely look through them. So as you search them, you don't really notice anything else on the corpses. There's nothing of note on any of them.
Even Jolly doesn't have any coins or nifty items.
Let me check him again, but I think you found what he had in his room, so stand by 1 second.
Oh, okay.
Hoard of coins and gemstones and chests.
Let me see if there was anything else on him that I missed.
You know, maybe a giant magical battle axe in his back pocket.
Exactly. Nope, you found what he had, so that was everything.
All right, since we went top last time, should we go bottom this time?
Yes.
Sure enough. We'll have, I'm guessing, the usual routine, having to check for traps.
So which way are you guys heading into one of these doors?
South.
Heading down to the South Town.
Okay, let's check for traps and if the door is unlocked.
Okay, so go ahead and roll a perception check in the tower. And you do not notice any traps. Then you just want to check to see if it's unlocked?
Yes.
So it is unlocked.
Okay, I would like to quietly peek in if I can.
Okay, stand by 1 second. So you peek in there and you see a plain dormitory featuring 6 bunk beds and a small wooden table and chairs, as well as 2 large laundry tubs and several baskets full of dirty clothes and linens. You see 3 commoners that are kind of busily working in there while you guys are in there. They're just kind of, they're cleaning, they're cooking, they're doing various things, but they kind of look up at you a little startled, but they don't really say anything. They just kind of stand there and kind of keep working as they're eyeing you, but don't really say anything.
Demarcos whispers, "Leave no witnesses."
Nice.
Flervin says to Demarcos, "What do you think? Magic missile?"
Oh, no. I'm going to step out of the way.
Just kidding. Into the north.
Well, we could talk to him. I don't know if there's anything we need to find out, but Demacos could scare the crap out of him.
Yeah, I'm not sure they're gonna know of anything of value.
Yeah. There is a door in there though.
So Enna, do me a favor and make a perception check for me in the tower.
Okay.
And to Makos, do the same for me.
Is that a perception check?
Yes, please.
Okay. Perception.
All right. So, Enna, are you checking that door?
Yes.
You're okay. Apparently oblivious to something.
All right, so go ahead and roll a perception check in the tower. Wow, they're horrible rolls. So, yeah, you don't notice any traps or anything.
Okay, and is it unlocked?
Yes, it is unlocked, sorry.
Okay, I would like to quietly peek into this room.
Okay, open it up. And while I'm doing that, yeah, well, stand by. I hate layers, guys. I like them, but I hate them. All right, so you see 2 large hearths on the north wall of this room that hold kettles full of simmering stew. You see wash basins and work tables with old, battered crockery standing in the middle of the room. Sacks, casks, and barrels are piled along the southern wall, and cheeses and smoked fish hang from the ceiling. So you also see another 5 commoners in here that are working. They again kind of look up for you a little bit quizzically, but they just return to their work and kind of look away and just keep busily working.
Yeah, and there's that blocked out area.
Yeah, I wonder where that's going.
My guess is stairs.
Yeah.
Must be just down, though.
Right.
That's not going up.
Just a guess.
Do me a favor, and actually, you can all roll an investigation checks in the tower.
Okay.
Now, is Barbar's disadvantage, will that be applied automatically? Or
it will. Okay. Actually, I don't know. It should. Yeah, it should be.
Okay.
That's right. It will be, definitely.
Yep, it shows it on there.
All right, so Flervin, you notice, and what was hard is you guys, it was after the encounter, you guys went straight up upstairs, but after you spent time to investigate the room, kind of behind this big like throne area, you actually see right behind the seat where Grimjaw, you could tell it was his kind of almost throne in this room. You notice a door in the wall behind him, and let me show you. That'll show up on the map. There we go. So the door, there's a door right there that looks like it's been concealed, but you can tell it's a door leading somewhere.
Well, yeah. Let's check that out.
Yeah, so I'd like to check out the door for traps and unlock, please.
Okay, and roll a perception in the tower. And you do not notice any traps, and it is in fact unlocked. You can tell it will push. Sorry, it is in fact unlocked, and you can tell it will push inward. And you do not think there's any traps, and it is unlocked. It's talking to the stream, but not the players.
We go in.
Might as well.
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay, I'd like to quietly walk in.
And you see a set of stairs going downward.
You called it. Well, shall we do it?
I don't see why not.
All right, Umber Hulks, here we come.
Nice. So let's do this just so I can get a few minutes as you guys are getting ready to head down there. Let's take our little break. Let's take 10 minutes and start back just after 8:30, and that'll give me a little time to open up what's down below.
Okay. Sounds good. Thanks,
Alan. Thanks, guys. All right, guys, they're going down to the boathouse. I love this. This will be really interesting if they actually go to this encounter, because this is where the ghouls are, and this is a pretty cool place, if I can find it. Hidden boat. I think that's where it is. Yes. Yes. Rob, I remember this. This was really cool. So we'll see how they do, because this is going to be challenging for them if they actually... Because, guys, this is a boat landing with a bunch of ghouls that will try to push them out of the boat, so this will be fun if they actually go about this. Just getting this kind of set up, then I'm going to go take my break real quick. But we'll see if they want to. I don't know if they're going to try to use the boats or not. We'll see what they do. on the map. Geez, big map. Is that really 5 feet? Is that 10 feet? Looks like it's already mapped. That's weird. All right, guys, I'll be back. About 5 minutes. Let me put that up on the stream. Scene. Let's do about 8 minutes left. Actually, we'll do 7. There we go. All right, guys, I'll be back. Yeah, hi Jumper. I'm going to go take a quick break. So let me know if other people are losing it too. I'm having a little bit of slowness over here, but everything seems like it's working fine. So let me know if you're losing audio, darn it. That'd be good to know. I'll be right back. Hey, hi, Jumper, I'm back. So yeah, I don't know. Let me check my voice meter, and it looks like I'm coming across fine there. I definitely have a lot of stuff open. So I don't know if that is, let me see what my task manager is showing. Wow, actually, Fantasy Grounds isn't using much at all. That's surprising. So everything looks like it's running good. So yeah, let me know if you have any other issues. I'm gonna try to resize this map. This is crazy. It is acting a little slow for me, though. So resize. I think that's just the kind of map it is. It's weird. I'm going to look in DeepBot and see if there's anything else I can figure out why that PD con isn't working. Exclamation point PD con, it's enabled. Why isn't that working?
Metallica?
When?
So that's the PDCon site, guys. I don't know why the it's not working. Oh, that's why. If I'd spell it right.
Chat.
I am here.
It's quiet.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me, guys?
Yep, I hear you now.
Could you not hear me before?
Uh-uh. No. I was just going to tell you, Cole saw that Metallica's coming out to play at Sports Authority Field June 7th.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it's pretty neat to play at the stadium.
Very cool. Thanks, High Jumper. I don't know what's going on. Let me put the stream back on so I don't
forget.
You going
to be in tomorrow?
Yes, I will.
You participating in Taste of Philly?
You know, I totally forgot about that. I don't know. Well, I didn't sign up or anything, so I guess not. I hadn't thought about it.
We place the orders like 15 minutes before we can pick it up. So if
okay,
you decide, there's still time, yeah.
Stand by 1 second. I'm going to check one other thing. Oh, good. You guys probably still hear that, right?
I hear some sound, yes.
Okay, good. All right, so is everyone back? I should have done a little check, but I think I heard everybody back. Or actually, no, it might not be.
Yeah, I don't know if he's back yet.
Good, High Jumper. I'm glad it looks good. And let me know if you hear any more problems with the sound. Have you guys heard, I mean, I know Enna said she had the one problem, but have you guys heard any other sound issues tonight?
No.
No.
I heard it cut out when she did, but other than that, I haven't heard anything else. I know you, it sounded like you expected me to hear you when I was just talking a few minutes ago, but I didn't hear you.
I might have had my finger on shift instead of control, I'm not sure.
Ah, okay.
Yes, I agree, High Jumper.
Yeah.
Everyone should sign up for PDCon, guys. And it should work now. That's right. I screwed up the exclamation point, but let me show you now. Oops. One sec.
Sounds very dungeony.
It does.
What, no back check marks?
That's what I meant, High Jumper. No back check marks? Before. What? I know, I almost did, but then I heard them back, and I'm like, I'll wait.
Okay, guys.
All right, so you guys, as you open up these stairs and come down, and I'll let you reorder, they kind of wind down deep below the keep, and at the bottom of the stairs, you find a torchlit chamber where two boats bob in an underground stream. And it's really dark and dank down here. The stream flows toward daylight to the east and leads upstream into darkness to the west. So I will show that to you. You can see that. And then you guys, I won't lock tokens to begin with. So if you guys want to move it around. And the map, I think it's because it's a small map. Everything looks huge, so you'll have to get used to that. But one sec.
Hear the drips.
Speaking of which, we never found out why the floor upstairs was wet, did we?
Nope.
Maybe we don't want to know.
Exactly. Maybe not.
Jolliver's personal outhouse.
Yeah.
So you guys see the map?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yep. All right.
And it is huge.
Yeah, it's weird. It's just, the characters look very big on it, and it's just the way it was, I guess.
Okay, so this must be a secret entrance to that hole in the wall we saw on the other side.
Could be. Looks like there's some boats. Some paddle boats.
Yeah, there are two boats, yep.
So do we explore the rest of the keep first and then come back here, or do we get in the boats and go paddling around to find other stuff?
Well, the only thing that I will say potentially against jumping in the boats is Barbar does have his exhaustion, so he will not be paddling very well or swimming should we tip the boat.
Oh, this will be interesting, guys.
I think we should explore.
Explore the keep?
Yes.
And then come back here later?
Yes.
Yeah, definitely. I think this is a neat area.
Probably a good call.
A little concerned about having to swim.
Well, it's kind of hard to fight in a boat if you have to.
Yeah. Lots of spells, perhaps.
Well, and arrows, but
yeah,
not much freedom of movement.
No.
Okay, so we'll head back up and explore, and then come back here later.
Okay.
Probably the safest bet.
They dodged a bullet, guys. They dodged a bullet.
Sorry, I'm sure you had to get all this map stuff set up. We're just nope.
It's all part of it. No, that's fine.
Looks like there's two boats missing.
Yeah, it's kind of hard to tell if those are other posts where the boats are tied off or not. All right, let me close that and bring you back on the other one.
So, thinking about where how we got to here, it's that hidden staircase behind Jolliver's throne is probably his, like you were saying, Furban. It's like a little hidden way for him to probably get in and out.
Right.
Him and his lackeys. Like Reesh. Back to you, right. Reesh.
Where you see Reesh?
No, just remembering the good old times when Reesh was up here. Shooting the shit with us.
All right, so you guys have the map up, and so we're all back in the kind of the lower or the ground floor level of this area. So tell me where you want to go or what you want to do.
Well, poor Nebula is still hanging out there. I don't know if that's a problem.
She's probably getting hungry.
Well, Gwydion mentioned she could be potentially hunting out there on her own.
Yeah.
I don't know. Is that something we need to go tend to Nebula? Or is she capable of looking after herself and remaining low-key while we're in here?
I think she's fine. I don't think she has any problem.
I see some blood splats. Is she eat something?
I think she's, you know, if you knew Nebula, you probably know she's gnawing on something.
Okay. This is true.
Yeah.
Someone's throat, perhaps. Come back, we'll be fat.
Yeah.
Should we head back out the main doors, though?
I think so.
Well, remember, too, we can, and I don't oppose that, but there's also the other option of the... There was the door upstairs that led out to the wall as well. So it just depends, you know, which direction we want to go, but...
And there is one guard. We don't know if there will be...
Right, more. I mean, the whole night has passed since then, plus some time today, so... But yeah, I mean, I'm fine with going out these doors, back out into the courtyard, and... telling everyone where you're...
We're here.
It seems like we'll be more hidden if we just go out through the courtyard.
Yeah, we'll have more opportunities for cover, certainly.
Okay.
All right.
Let's do it.
I'm glad the sounds seem to resolve, yeah, Tie Jumper.
It's worth checking to see if someone came and booby-trapped the door with us.
Like I said, I've got a lot of programs running at the same time, well, that's for sure.
Those Reavers and Leash came in, I don't think so.
Assuming they didn't come up the secret stairs.
This is true.
Okay, just to be caught on the safe side, let's check for traps as we leave.
Okay, go ahead and roll perception in the tower.
Remember, he is a slightly mad DM.
That's right.
He's tried to kill us before.
Exactly. You did not notice any traps.
You want to peek out, make sure there's no one happen to be patrolling right here right now?
Yeah.
There's no tomorrow?
I would like to peek out before we walk out.
Okay, you peek out and you do not see anyone walking around as you peek out the door.
Okay.
Let's go. Shall we?
All right. Time to clear this place out.
Time to clear it out like a colon cleanse.
Thank you for that visual.
Exactly. I was thinking the same thing.
Must be the coffee talking.
Wet floors.
I didn't see what color the wetness was. So there's a door right by us.
And there is. Who
shot that from above? We have no idea.
Should we check this door?
Yeah, let's check it out.
Okay. Check for traps, and if it's unlocked, please.
Speed of a mongoose.
Go ahead and make your perception check. So, you do not notice any traps. Is that that was the first check, right?
Yes.
And it does appear to be unlocked.
Say, there appear to be some windows over here. Should we peek inside or attempt opening the door first?
Well, the only problem with that is that if we go around the corner, we may expose ourselves to somebody standing over there.
This is true.
Yeah. All
right. Good point.
Okay. Want me to quietly open the door, guys? Or, Barbar, do you want to
do
your stuff?
I think the
stealth mode is always a good choice when it's an option.
Okay. I like to slowly peek inside. Quietly.
Okay, go ahead and roll a stealth check in the tower. Okay, so as you slowly open the door and it kind of creaks open, but as soon as you open it a crack, you hear kind of this booming voice of a preacher, and it's a woman who is just, she's going on and on about the truth of the deep waters, and everyone needs to follow the cult of the crushing wave and the great revelations from the all-powerful Gar Shatterkeel. Everyone needs to learn this is the path of the righteous. And she just keeps going on and on as you're kind of crack open the door and they haven't noticed you. But you do see a couple of other reavers that are in there as you slowly open the door. So let me show you a little bit what that looks like. One second.
Oh, so is the preacher closest to the door?
She is.
Oh. I say we either help them meet their maker, or we just close the door and be on our way. Not interested in service today.
Someone's gonna shut her up.
Yeah, I think we should need to go in there.
Let's do it.
We've walked into worse.
This is true.
Oh God.
All right, and this
looking
is
looking good.
This is kind of what. Yeah, it's a. I guess it's a unisex version.
Oh, I think the fish hooks cover up anything.
But I thought that was kind of cool looking. Okay, so.
It's
cool.
Yes, it's really cool.
So what are you doing? You guys are kind of walking in, or what? Tell me how you want to play this as you're kind of walking in.
Well,
I always like the option where the dwarf goes raging and yelling at the top of his lungs.
All right.
Yeah, I'm about the way.
Let's do it. I'm assuming I can apply rage prior to running in.
You can. I mean, is your intention to run in and attack, or yeah? I mean,
oh
you can.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I'm barging in, shoving an axe right in her face.
Okay, well, I mean, you can definitely apply rage, but as you barge open the door, everyone roll initiative for me.
Oh. I thought she was lost in the sermon.
Oh, that was a bad roll.
No surprise for us.
That was weird. Yeah, so much for that.
All right, so the readers that...
I be right here.
Yeah, that's fine. The reavers who were kind of like looking up at her like blah 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 as you opened the door, they were looking for any opportunity to do something other than listen to this sermon. So they see you and they immediately launch into an attack. So number 7 is up.
Bring it on.
She leaps around. Let's actually, you know what she's going to do? She's going to stay where she is, and she's going to throw a javelin at you. So she targets Barbar. Throws a javelin and hits him. And does eeny-beeny damage. I don't even know if it did anything. Yeah, it did one, I think.
Did one.
Mm-hmm.
Reaver 3, she gets her option... And she's going to do the same thing. She throws a javelin at him. And it hits. And does a little damage. And Barbar. Oh, that was a good rage sound. Barbar's up.
Alright, Barbar. Let's get up here. What do you think, guys? Should I frenzy? If I do, the second level exhaustion is half speed.
Yeah, it's just three of them. Let's...
Okay.
Let's just do normal.
Okay.
Can you hit? And do a little damage to her.
Oh, God. She must be healthy as an ox. All right. I don't think I have any bonus actions. Let me see. No. All right. Shit.
All right, stand by.
Hi, Barbar.
Say, I like your garb.
Okay.
No chance in sweet talking, I guess, after you hit her with an axe.
That's right.
Hey, fish hooks, want to get a drink?
All right, so let's see what she's going to do. She mumbles and looks at Barbar and raises her hands and does this. Make sure she has them targeted. See if this works. Oh, man. And nothing happens, but you feel very fortunate, Barbar, but nothing happens.
All right, guys. Time to burn this bitch down.
I think so.
Damn it. Hold person didn't work, guys. I was very close.
And lay waste.
All right, Darvik's up.
Okay, Darvik's going to prance on in there.
Damn it, I was hoping that whole person. I knew that was a little bit of a gamble. But Barbar is Characters are moving pretty slow. Oh, sorry, did you have another move?
I did, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, it's moving really slow for me, so I think I just... Computer's starting to say this has been a lot of memory.
So much. There we go.
All right, there we go.
Okay, I think it's time for another inflict wounds.
Okay. And it misses.
Okay, as a bonus action, I'm going to cast Spiritual Weapon.
Ooh.
Okay, stand by 1 second. Okay, Spiritual weapons can't flank, but it is there if you... And you do get to attack, I think, this same round, right?
Yes.
Okay, go for it.
Son of a gun.
And it's a miss.
Damn. Tuna.
All right.
My frenzy's looking more and more like a better option.
Yeah.
All right, Enna.
I didn't mean to walk through the wall.
Okay, if you want to go ahead and redo the move and just show me kind of how you want to do it, that's fine. And I'll wait till you're done if you want it. There you go. Okay, cool.
Okay.
Is it moving pretty quickly on your end? Because on my end, it's like she's like slowly getting over there.
It's not too bad.
Okay, good.
Yeah, it looks normal for me. Yeah.
Good. Must be the fact that I have like 20 programs open.
I need to get you massive amounts of RAM or something.
No, yeah. It's going pretty good, but every once in a while it just slows down. All right, so Enna, who are you attacking?
Number 7.
Lucky number 7.
Yes.
Mama wants a new pair of shoes.
She actually just got some today.
Nice. And she hits.
Sweet.
Ooh, solid damage as it slams into her stomach.
Nice.
And she breaks off the arrow and throws it down and kind of waves her hand towards you. Like, come on.
Wow.
She broke the arrow? Bitch.
Bitch.
That's pretty hardcore.
It is.
That is.
All right, Demacos. Let's see. Yeah.
Save this up here for the XP.
I'm trying to map out how far you can go.
No problem.
You should be able to get to the east side of Dargavit.
That's what I'm attempting to do. Oops.
I agree. We gotta take her down.
Yeah. Well, shit. I can't get it to let me do the multiple moves.
The Lord, yeah, says just, you got to rise up.
Here. Let me just move to here, and I'll finish moving after it gets there. Every time I try to drag the movement to the next square, is it just reverts back.
Hmm. Okay.
I don't know why.
And you're grabbing, the very end of it?
Yeah.
Huh. Weird.
Yeah, what it would do is revert back and act like I'm moving to the square right beside me instead of where I'm actually telling it to go. So I don't know, but
okay. And if you want to move where the spiritual weapon is, I can move it up. Just don't move it on top of it because it'll stack.
It's not a bad option for flanking, but then I can get flanked. So I don't know if that's a good idea.
I'll just leave it there. I mean, it doesn't matter. It is where it is. Just you can stay where you are, but just in case anybody's going to move there.
Yeah. Wouldn't be bad for Barbar, but I'm afraid Demacos would get flanked, and he's kind of squishy. All right. Let's see.
What is he going to do next time?
All right. Here we go.
And it's a hit.
Sweet. Come on. Something big. Yeah, not bad.
All right. She's hurting. She felt that.
Let's see here. Oh, okay. I'll just stay there for now.
Third's going to scoot in on the action.
Okay.
Now, I'm assuming that I should be able to hit him line of sight, do you think? Or her, rather.
I'll give that to you. Yeah, that's fine.
I think we're going to go with the triple scorching ray again.
Okay.
I apologize in advance for the sound effects.
No, I love it.
Yeah.
All right, not that one.
Missed the first one. I don't think they trigger until you damage. Second one hit.
That's some big damage right there.
Ooh, minimum damage. Ooh.
Loving it.
I see some double sixes.
And that's a hit. Oh, it's better, much better.
Nice.
She's hurting. All right, Crushing Weaver 7. She's going to chuck a spear at Enna. So one second.
A spear?
Javelin, excuse me.
Oh.
They don't seem to be interested in close range combat.
No, that hasn't worked for them so well this campaign. And that's a miss.
Sweet.
So then they go on to number 3 is going to throw a spear at Demakos. Spear, javelin, whatever, javelin. And I haven't even been drinking anything tonight.
What do you think?
Right, exactly. All right. And it's a hit. And does a little damage.
Going to activate Hellish Rebuke.
Okay.
Demakos.
Yep.
Targeted.
And she fails her save. Ooh, and she is hurting. That was a flame of... This huge jet of fire comes flying back at her and doesn't take her down, but she's kind of patting herself out, putting out the fire.
Sweet. All right, so Barbar, I think I'm going to hold off on Frenzy.
Okay.
Might be all right. I feel a good roll coming on. Damn!
Do you now?
So much for that.
All right.
Oh, shit.
All right. So Drosnin raises up her hands and begins to cast a spell. And one second. See if I can put it on her. I need to see if this works. Let's see if there's anything else she can do. Hold on. And that's all she can do. Okay. Darvik's up.
All right. Darvik's going to take another swing with the spiritual weapon.
And it hits.
So now, do all attacks against her have disadvantage? Wow.
You're not sure, but you know that one.
Well, that one did.
Yeah, that one did. You can. Okay. I mean, I will say that you see her, and as everyone's looking at her, I mean, she's really hard to see. It's almost as if she's moving extremely fast, but staying where she is, and it's very hard to make out her shape and exactly where she is.
Interesting. Huh. That means it's going to be awfully hard to hit her with any of the spells that I have. All right.
Now that hit, didn't it?
Yep.
Okay, hold on.
That one did.
Let me check something. See if I need to roll for her. Because I probably do. Got a lot I have to scroll through here, so bear with me. Yeah, so I do. One second. Okay. All right. So whatever's, what's next?
That is the question. Now, Guiding Bolt, let's see. It gives the next attack roll advantage. So that would just nullify
correct.
The next person's attack disadvantage? Okay.
That's right.
Let's try that. Probably going to miss, but it's worth a shot. Yeah, that's a miss, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Okay.
It was worth a shot.
Okay, I'm going to target Reaver 7 again.
Okay. Ooh, and you hit. Whoa. Solid hit.
Nice.
Ooh, and that kind of catches her in the side of her throat. And she's gurgling blood.
Nice.
Demacus. All right, Demacus. Come on now. Doesn't have any inspiration, unfortunately. So, here we go.
And that is a hit. Wow, with disadvantage at 22.
Wow. He means business.
Apparently.
5 plus 4, 9. The batch is still standing. Alright.
Still here.
Let's see. Let me see. 5, 3. Just trying to figure out if he wants to move. Really put himself in a bind. Yeah, maybe not. I don't know. Maybe I should. Should we put him up there and flank? Knowing he'll probably get flanked.
Like you said, he's a little bit squishy.
Yeah. Just trying to counteract her disadvantage. Yeah. Alright.
Well, hopefully Flervin's got this one.
Burn her down.
Yep, we're going to cast Magic Missile as a second level spell.
Ooh. That's some seriousness.
All right, and she is down.
Yes.
Hold on. She is down, but I'm just trying to. I want to read something so I know this for next time. One second. Actually, I take that back. So, as the magic missiles go flying toward her, she throws up her hand, and the missiles essentially disintegrate against an invisible barrier that comes up right in front of her.
Of course they do.
Yes, they do. So let me put this on her real quick. One second. If it'll let me. I'll have to do it manually. One sec. All right. Huh. Crashing Reaver 7 is going to get up close and personal. She's going there and pulls out her longsword. And I think does nothing if I'm reading the dice right. Yes, she misses Enna. And number three, she's going to go there and attack with her longsword at Demakos. And miss again. And Barbar is up.
Barbar would like to move up to where the spiritual weapon is.
Okay, let me move it. Go for it.
Okay.
Flanky, flanky.
Yes. And so, that's advantage or plus two? I always forget.
It's advantage.
Okay. Come on, Barbar.
Now, did you have exhaustion? So did they have advantage and disadvantage? It looks like they canceled out.
Yeah.
Okay, and that was that missed. Oh, you kind of feel. I mean, you think it almost got through to her, but you just feel it clank off of some invisible barrier.
You got frenzy on, right? So you get to do it again.
No, I never put it on.
You don't.
Right. Okay. All right. So let me read this just to make sure I take this off at the right time. Okay, hold on. I need to. 1 second. Okay, and she is going to reach out at Barbar. It's already targeted. And hits. And does a little, that's interesting, untyped damage. It should be necrotic, so you feel a cold chill go through you as she touches you. All right, and Darvik is up.
All right, first we're going to let the spiritual hammer have a swing.
Don't forget, we're flanking. Oh, that doesn't get flanking, does it?
Nope. It hits, though. And you notice, you think that the shield, that the invisible, whatever was up is now gone. And the hammer slams into her and she's down.
Yes, for real this time?
For real this time.
No wave of the hand?
No, the one thing that you guys, for the future, as you guys level up, what I was looking at is for shield, you can cast it as a reaction, and as soon as magic missile is cast against you, you can throw it up before it does any damage, and you take no damage at all from any magic missiles.
That's what I thought. That sounded like shield.
So it's kind of a cool, I mean, it's actually a pretty neat spell.
Yeah.
Especially against Darvik, or Flurvin rather, because he's magic missile happy pretty much all the time.
Yeah. Oh, it's a, yeah. Hey, lazy student.
Okay, Darvik's going to get up close and personal.
Fireball on her. All right. Thanks for coming in, lazy student. Still in Riverguard Keep, fighting their way out.
Low on spells, or at least he is. So he's going to use his Mace of Heavenly Fate, which always misses, and take his way.
Okay. Now, you haven't targeted yet, right? Okay, there we go.
Yep.
Okay.
And it's a hit.
For once.
Nice.
Not so nice.
Little damage.
It's something.
Okay, I would like to attack Reaver 7 with my short sword.
Okay.
Time to cut a bitch.
And you hit. And oh. She is down. You nice. Slice her across the stomach, and she tries to hold her guts in as they spill out on the floor.
So can I move and get the other reaver with my offhand?
Well, the only thing that, since you had your bow out, you can drop your bow and grab your short sword, but you can only grab one weapon right now.
Right.
So you can move, but hold on, I mean, oh yeah, that's right, that's because that would be your bonus attack, so yeah, that's all you can move, but you can't attack again.
Okay, I'll just stay where I'm at.
Okay.
Still nice.
Yeah, that was good.
What we got here? What we got here? Demacos. Oh, snap, Demacos. I am within touch range. That is not so good. Let me see here. See within range. Son of a... Well, I can Misty Step.
You can't antagonize him blasphemous range?
No, because it's a ranged spell, and I'm technically within touch distance.
Right.
I was just making sure. I thought I had a... Damn.
Well, what about stepping around on the other side so that you're flanking and then just taking a swing?
Well, I don't even have a... I have a crossbow equipped. I don't even have a melee weapon equipped, apparently.
Oh.
So, I think I'm going to Misty Step so I can get within range, because that's a bonus action, and I can still attack her.
Okay.
So, I'll just Misty Step to, say, here. I will check off... Oh, actually, I need to check off two spells, because I already used Hellish Rebuke as well. So, there goes those. Target.
And all that for nothing.
Darn it. It goes flying above her head into Anna. No, it doesn't hit Anna.
Oh, no.
Damn it.
Flervin's feeling cheap. He's just going to firebolt.
All right.
Pew pew.
And why doesn't it look like you... I see you cast it. What's that?
I was just guessing that.
Yeah. I'll have to look because it didn't target her until after. It was weird. It was almost like you targeted after because it's not showing me if you hit. Let me open her real quick. So that is a miss.
Yeah.
She pulls up her shield, and the firebolt blasts off the shield and harmlessly into the floor.
She yells, "Ha ha!"
And she decides to take a swing at Damako or Darvik, since he's the only one right in front of her.
Better make it count, lassie. Your days are numbered.
And she misses. She really made it count. All right, Barbar.
Now, quick question. Should we aim to knock her unconscious and question her? We've pretty much killed everybody else in here.
That's probably not a bad idea. So... All right. I'm not trying to move past her. I'm trying to move around her. And God damn, this thing will not let me do this for the life of me. There kind of goes. There it goes.
Okay.
Okay. So,
Barbar, even though he's thoroughly pissed at this point, is going to attempt to knock her unconscious and not completely kill her. If he hits at all.
And he misses.
What a fucking joke, Barbar.
Alright, Darvik's going to try the same thing if he hits.
I didn't even roll advantage. Make sure you put advantage on.
Yeah, definitely.
Because we're flanking.
Well, and if you want to roll, Barbar, you can roll another.
Okay,
it's a hit.
I should remember these things.
And she's critical.
That bitch is still up.
Oh, wait. Can I do the whole knock unconscious with the spiritual weapon?
I'll let you do that. I'm not really sure what the ruling is on that. You can't do it with a ranged weapon, but I'd let you do it with a spiritual weapon.
Okay. Good chance here.
And that definitely knocks her unconscious.
Sweet. Well, Darvik, you should probably have the honor since you thought of it and knocked her out.
Why, hello, young lady. I'm the one who knocked you out.
Well, isn't Demakos the one with the high intimidation?
Yeah.
He's definitely got high charisma.
Yeah, I mean, he's got the... He is... What am I thinking of? Proficient with intimidation. But yeah, he has the high charisma, so...
Yeah, I think you should try an intimidator to talking.
All right, what do we want to know?
The delegation. We won. At least we didn't really get much information from the last place.
Okay. So, Demakos is... kind of slapping her in the face and wake up!
Thanks, Lazy Sooner. You too, man. Have a good night.
What do you know about a missing delegation that came through this area? What would it be? Gosh. It was weeks ago at this point? At least a few days ago.
So are you... Are you trying to intimidate? What are you trying to do so we can...
Yeah, let's intimidate her.
Okay, so go ahead and roll that in the tower.
Okay. Blah.
Okay. So she kind of shakes off the cobwebs and kind of looks up at you and, eyes really wide and she says, I know nothing of a delegation. I'm here simply to support the cult of the Crushing Wave and our leader, Gar Shatterkeel, who will ultimately rule this valley.
Tell us more about... Oh, go ahead.
I'm just going to ask, is that a new name? I think it is.
Well, I think we heard the preacher lady babbling on about it.
You did. Okay. Good job. Yes, you did.
So, anyway. Yeah.
You did?
Okay. So, Demakos will... resume his interrogation and say, well, tell us all you know. Tell us more about this Gar Shatterkeel. Keel?
And she says, yeah. Gar Shatterkeel resides, deep further down the river in a temple, and he's down there to get as many converts as he can and to train them to ultimately take over this valley, and he will not fail. I have every confidence in the world that he will take over this valley and you will all be dead.
Further down the river, which direction is this? Is this, I don't know which way the river's flowing.
He says it's down deep below this keep to the west.
Ah. Would this perhaps be the waterway beneath the down the secret stairway and behind Jolliver's throne.
Yes, that is the way to Gar Shatterkeel, and I encourage you, go find him, go seek him out. I'm sure a party as strong as you would have no problems with that temple and all that lies within it. And then she just grows quiet.
You lying sacka.
Yeah. Well, tell him you called him a bitch.
I think we need to tell her that we know she's lying and she needs to give us some information about what lies ahead of us, or we'll slit her throat.
No, or we won't slit her throat and make her suffer.
That too.
Okay.
We'll feed you to the panther.
That's right.
Yeah.
We've done it before.
She's definitely still, you can tell she's still intimidated, but she says, I know nothing more other than, you know, Gar is very powerful, and that's all I know. She basically tells you she's a new convert. She said, I was here listening to the priest as she was indoctrinating us into the cult, but I am a very new convert, and that's all I know.
We can tell you're bored out of your skull. You weren't really listening to this. Why are you here?
I'm here because I believe in Gar Shatterkeel, and this is part of what we have to go through in order to become a full-fledged member of the cult. Whatever. That's what I'm going with, guys.
Where did they find you? If you're a new addition to the cult, where did they find you? Where do you come from?
We come from everywhere. I come from far up north, but their recruits are coming in every day to the cult.
Cool.
I don't know, guys. Just coming up with stuff.
Yeah. Which limb would you prefer be eaten first by the panther?
I'll ask her to give us one good reason why we should let her live.
Okay. Assuming you would like to go on living, why should we let you?
She says, I have done you no harm. You came in to attack us. I was only defending myself. Why should you kill me?
Well, number one, because I want to.
Gotta love Demacos. Well, your cult is a scourge on the entire surrounding area. We should be wiping the whole earth clean of you people. Why should you in particular be spared?
And she just grows quiet and doesn't say anything else.
All right, Demacos, all yours.
All right, well.
Wow, this is a brutal party, man. Demacos, they're just gonna execute her. She's done.
See something real quick.
Put stable on her just so they can kill her. That's probably what they're going to do.
Trying to see if Demacos choke her out with his mage hand, but I don't think he can.
I just put stable on her since she was stabilized.
Okay. Well,
for now.
She's a little too close for me to cast anything on her, so Demacos is just going to step on her throat and crush it.
Ouch.
Wow. Alright, so you step in it, and as you step on her throat, her windpipe is crushed, and she tries to gurgle and dies. And the party is now all chaotic evil. Alright, so that was fun for all the kids on the channel today. No, I'm just kidding.
I was trying to ask her what was good about her so we wouldn't have to kill her.
She's
quiet.
She was a new convert, man. She's under the she was under the spell.
Just drink the Kool-Aid.
Yeah.
Well, good riddance.
All right.
Should we search the corpses, perhaps?
Yeah, I guess. See if there's any maps or anything that'll help us on our way over to... was it Tar Heel?
Gar Shatterkeel? Alright, let me give you your XP real quick. Hold on.
Yep.
Okay.
Demacos is a little curious if this priest lady had anything on her. Other than fish hooks.
Jeez, nice.
We should use that as an action.
Yank on the fish.
Disadvantage from now on.
Nope, she doesn't have anything else on her.
Oh. So she truly was worthless.
I would like to try and pull the arrow out of Reaver 7's neck that's lying on the ground next to me.
Did you just shoot one?
I shot two. One of them was, she broke, and the other one went through her. It was stuck in her neck.
Okay. So if you shot two, go ahead and roll a d4. And you get them both back.
You managed to get one back because the other one should
say again. Oh, that's right. That's right. That's right. You get one back. That's right. Thank you. How long is spiritual weapon? I assume is it off or is it?
It's a fine question. 1 minute. So yeah, that's good.
Okay. I like the token though.
Definitely.
Mm-hmm.
All right. You guys are getting closer. I think you're about 1,000 XP away.
Sweet.
Yes, that is pretty sweet.
Fifth level's pretty cool. I think a lot of you guys get extra attacks at fifth level, I think.
Well, yeah, you move into sort of that next tier of adventurer, don't you?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. And it's regional, I believe.
Something like that, yeah. All right, well, should we... search this room?
Might as well, since we're here.
Alright, whoever's going to search, go ahead and roll investigation checks in the tower for me.
Let's see here. Investigation. Oh, why not, Barbar? You can participate.
You can. So you guys kind of turn everything upside down and you see a bunch of books with rantings of the cult of the crushing wave, and you see the water cult symbol everywhere, but you don't see anything else in the room.
Are the books sort of like their Bible?
No, it's just more just rantings. There's not, like, you don't see a formal, any kind of formal, like, you know, Bible or, something that is the tenets of the cult or anything like that.
Okay. All right. Mm-hmm. Well, should we head out to the west where we came from or to the east with the double doors?
I would think to the east. Looks like it's going back outside.
Should, let's see. I guess we can worry about that in a minute. Yeah, we can head east. Why not?
I would like to check the doors for traps and they're unlocked.
No traps and they're unlocked. I won't make you roll on this one.
Oh, wow. Sounds suspicious.
I like to just peek out.
Okay, So you see, kind of, it definitely opens outside into a courtyard. Let me open a little bit more. Stand by. So it opens out into the rest of the courtyard. You see kind of stairs leading up to where it looks like the east wall area, and then obviously the cliffs that lead down to the water below on the kind of the southeast. Jeez, too far?
Should we go outside or should we go out the other way?
This seems fairly safe. I mean, I think there's a kind of a cliff to the water for a lot of it. There's a door up above us. Like if we were to go out. Yeah. Excuse me. I don't know. What do you guys want to do?
I think we should check out the tower.
Let's do it.
What say you, Anna?
So tower it is?
Yep.
Yeah, my move marker is doing crazy stuff.
Yeah, I wonder if it's... I don't know. I wonder if it is the fact... Next time I'll definitely have you guys upgrade. I mean, I don't know if it really makes a difference, but it could.
So, wait. You're saying there's... not a door there? What?
No. I'm sorry. I'm talking about the your movement. But yes, there is a door there.
Oh.
I just meant next time I'll make sure you guys go up to 3-point, you know, whatever version.
Yeah.
Because I don't know if that's making a difference, but it's possible it is.
I'd like to check the traps and if this is unlocked.
Okay. Go ahead and roll perception in the tower. And it you do not find any traps, and it is unlocked.
Okay, peeking in quietly.
Okay, roll stealth check in the tower. Okay, and you open quietly, and you see filthy furs and discarded bones litter the interior of this tower. A rank animal stench hangs in the air, and you also see these four guys that are kind of all milling around, kind of look like they're bored. They're kind of pushing each other around, but let me show you what they look like. 1 second. They look kind of like that. Let me open them so they don't look like they're in space. I'll unmask.
Oh, God.
And did you say if they see me?
They do not. They do not right now.
So, new plan. Close the door very quietly and let's go back and take a long rest. Although we probably can't.
Probably not a long rest. You could probably try a short rest somewhere, but not a long rest.
Might be worth it. I know Barbar's kind of reeling a little bit and
I think Demacus gets his spell slots back on a short rest.
He does, and then you can use some of Barbar's hit dice.
Right. Yeah, he's got 4. I'm not sure how many he can use, but...
I think you can use as many as you want.
Yeah.
You can. You just only get back... I always forget. You only get back a certain amount, yeah, on a long rest.
All right, well, let's see if she can close the door quietly.
Yeah.
Get that through first. All
right, and roll a stealth check in the tower.
You notice Demako stayed back.
Yes, both vicious and the coward. I like it.
All right, and you kind of hear the latch click a little bit, and it's just a touch loud, but after it stops, you don't hear anything else happen, so you think you're okay.
Okay.
Da, da, da.
Okay, without making Alan do all kinds of map stuff, can we go back to the hidden room and take a short rest and just sort of do that? Or
yeah, which so when you say the hidden room, which one are you talking about? The one semicircle one?
Yeah.
Okay, 1 second.
Behind the bookshelf.
Got a lot of windows open. That might be part of my problem. So give me 1 second. Boy, now it's a lot faster. I think that was part of it, but hold on. I might not have put you in the right layer. No, I did. All right, can you all see the bars and all that?
Yep.
Yep.
Yes.
Yay. Okay. So so tell me how you want to play this. And then you got the door right across from where Flurbin is. You guys can move your tokens. I just threw you in here. But we're going to try for a short rest.
Yeah, I think Barbar is going to place his hunting trap again up at the, I don't necessarily want to move up here, but up by the...
That's fine. Okay.
Yeah. Then he's going to get out of the way. I think Demacos is in a good spot. Although he's apparently tilting over.
I don't know if that was me or you, but I put him back. Enna called dibs. I got the bed.
Yeah.
Mart elf.
All right. So I tell you what, Barbar, roll, unless there's anything else you guys want to do, roll me a d20 in the tower.
Barbar shall do that.
All right, and your short rest is uneventful. 1 sec.
All right. Can I go ahead and roll some hit die for Barbar?
Yeah, I just I applied the short rest, but yeah, now whoever wants to do the hit dice can do them.
That'll probably do.
Rob's got such a long effect built in this one, it'll like, you'll hear a fire crackling and birds forever if I don't turn it off, but I'm going to wait till you guys are done. I love it, it's awesome.
Why not? I'll go ahead and fully heal up.
Okay, so that's 3, 2, 3, 1. All right. Anything else anybody else needs to do and pretty much healed up?
No, Barbar's going to pick up his hunting trap.
Okay, so it's about 8 o'clock in the evening. Actually, I'm sorry. That was a short rest. It's only once. Stand by. Yeah, that's right. It's just midday. It's about 11 a.m. Yep. There we go. All right. So you guys are kind of pretty healed. You're almost at fifth level. You don't know that yet, but so yeah.
Oh, I didn't realize DeMarcus was wounded. Shoot. Is it too late for him to roll hit dice?
No, you can do it. That's fine.
I don't know how I missed that, but I did. Alright, sorry about that.
That's right.
Gosh, I just didn't even see it on the screen for some reason. Barbar's exhaustion still stays until a long rest. That's right.
Yep.
Okay.
Alright, should we head back?
Have we got time to clear them out? If they're still there?
Yeah, do you want to hit? Yeah, one sec. Let me put it back over there.
Hopefully we can make short work of them. The magic of teleportation.
Exactly. Yeah, it is a lot snippier. I wonder if it's because I had so many windows open.
Probably.
Just had a lot of story entries. So you guys can remove yourself. I just kind of generally put where I thought you might be.
Well, this is probably good.
Yep.
I'm gonna move Barbar up one. You guys want Barbar to do one first?
Yeah, that sounds good.
Send in the meat shield.
Pretty much.
I gotta see something. His rage. I always forget. Let's see. Long rest. Okay. Alright, well. I'm gonna scoop Demacos up a little bit as well. It's right there. Alright, Barbar. Let's go.
Alright, let's roll initiative as he slams open the door. Everybody roll initiative.
Nice.
Enna, very nice.
Oh, she's itching to go. Well, of course, I stopped right in front of the door, so you get the pleasure of moving through, Barbar.
But you can do that. At least that's good.
Yeah.
All right, Enna, your first act.
Okay.
Oh, stuck.
That's my fault. I thought she was done. And I think that might end your movement.
Okay. So 5, 10, 15, 20. Yeah.
Because you had to move. Yeah, moving through him was 10, so. All right. The bugbears look at you. Ah, attack! Kill them all! Kill them all!
I am gonna target. Who am I trying to say? Whoa!
And you hit.
Tellies? Nice. Oh my.
Wow, heavy damage.
That's and a way to start things off.
Gotcha.
Goes reeling from that shot. Nice shot.
Let's see here. I think I can get to there. That'd be 25, counting 10 through Barbar.
Yep.
Okay. Alright.
That's awesome, Duff. And that's a solid agonizing blast hit. That's great to hear, Duff, man. That's great. Very cool. Nice damage.
Not bad.
It's gonna be fun.
Alright, Barbar.
Barbar could scoot in just a little bit more.
Yeah. Should I go up? Or, yeah, I kind of want to get right in front of Enna, probably.
Yeah, and you don't want to get flanked either.
Right. So he will scoot up. He is going to rage it up.
Yeah.
Probably be taking a long rest only takes away one level of exhaustion, doesn't it?
Yes.
Alright, I'm not going to frenzy it.
Unless anybody has greater restoration.
Untarget Barbar. Alright. Bugbear?
And it's a miss. That black bear number 10 is not happy. He pulls out this huge morning star. Goes here and attacks Enna. And hits. That's 15 damage.
Whoa.
Bugbear 3 swings at Barbar. Suspense. Oh, and he misses. Bugbear 6.
Suspenseful sounding.
Oh. And he hits.
Yo!
Wow!
And Enna is critical.
One.
No!
Barbara, we might want to rethink that frenzy.
Yeah, probably gonna have to. It's gonna get in exhaustion debt.
And the Bugbear 7 attacks Demakos and misses. Darvik is up.
Oh boy.
Is the sounds too loud, guys, or is the music just about right for Sirenscape right now? I'm talking to the stream, sorry, not the players.
Alright, Darvik's gonna take an inflict wound swing at Bugbear 6.
I might need to I'm actually usually test with the players. That's a hit. Nice hit. So, I think I'll be good, Duff, but I'll let you know. Ooh, 19 points of damage and Bugbear 6 is down.
Well done.
Yes, nice, Darvik.
As a bonus action, gonna cast.
Oh, sorry, you're talking to High Jumper, not me. Sorry.
Nice.
Very nice. Oh, spiritual weapon. Here it comes. Wait for it.
Wait for it.
Where do you. So who are you going after? Not that it has to be right on them.
Bugbear, I think it's 10.
Yeah, right below, right next to Enna. Yep, you got it.
Yeah.
Ooh, and that's a hit.
Ooh.
Solid nice. Hit. 12 points of damage. Flervin's like, is it okay to come in?
Yes, come be armed. We need your help. Now here's a question. If I wanted to cast Burning Hands in a cone, could I do it between Barbar and Darvik and hit the two bugbears?
Between Darvik and
Barbar.
That's a good question. And hit the two. You could probably hit the one, but well, it's a cone.
Yeah.
Let me see. Hold on.
It would probably depend on how far it spreads out.
Yeah, I guess I'll allow it because it's right from you in the corner. I'm not sure. Yeah, I'll allow it. I don't think I'd let you get more than two in there. So if there was a third, I'd probably say just two, but I'll let you attack those two. So one succeeded, one failed. And they're burning. But not dead yet.
I'm going to cast Cure Wounds on myself.
Good call.
Okay.
Give yourself a target.
She did.
Hey, not bad.
Cool. Yeah, that was good. That was 8 points.
Yeah.
Now hold on a second. Let me look at something real quick.
Okay.
Because it was Cure Wounds, right?
Yes.
Why isn't it, let's see, it should be based on your wisdom. Why isn't it giving your modifier?
Hmm.
1 second. It looks, it says spells, ability, attack, base. 1 second. Yeah, I don't know. I think you needed to change the ability in your spell level to wisdom. It was blank. So so go ahead. I'm going to give you two more because you should have gotten the 8 plus 2 because you did roll an 8. So 1 second.
Okay.
Okay, so you have 21, one wound. So you got two more points back.
8.
Okay.
And I think that's all I can do because that's an action, isn't it?
Right, it is.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
The only healing word is the only one that's a bonus action.
Oh, Demacos. Time to misty step. Oh my.
This one's quieter. The other one was pretty cool, but it was a little loud. Alright, you're gonna misty step?
Yep, right over to here. Okay. And let me just double check. Yeah. Oh yeah.
So 7 failed and 3 succeeded. So go ahead and yeah, just. And 7 is wiping off acid, frantically trying to scrape it off of his hide. But he's not dead.
Alright, Marmar. What do you think? Should I still frenzy? Anyone?
Up to you.
Oh, Duff, that's a great idea.
It wasn't looking good there for a minute.
That's a right. Great. That's a great idea, Duff. I like that.
Seems to be to link them all.
It's gonna be fun, guys. Thanks for joining
yeah,
and
we'll okay.
Jumping on. Yeah, so. Next time I'll organize, or we'll, so. We can all organize it. I threw it together. Okay. That's awesome.
I'll just keep him targeted then.
God. And it's a miss.
Barbar. You suck tonight.
No, he's exhausted, man.
He sucks tonight. Don't cut him any slack. He's a barbarian.
That's a good point. All right, so he's going to keep swinging at the ranger. He smells blood. And he hits.
Oh.
And
she's down.
Woman down.
Ooh.
bugbear is going to swing at Barbar. And he hits. Bugbear 7 is going to swing at Barbar. Missed. And Darvik is up.
Unfortunately, Darvik is out of healing spells. However, I can channel Divinity.
And you have Spirit of the Dying, right? Oh, no, you can't. Yeah, you have Spirit of the Dying.
I do, as a cantrip. Let's see, Channel Divinity. I can restore her to no more than half of her hit point max. So that would be 16.
Sorry, I'm trying to look her. Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. Okay, so I have a maximum of 20. So let's give 16 to Enna. And nobody else is below half their hit points, so I guess that's all I can do with that.
Right. Okay.
And then I'll use my bonus action to attack with the Spiritual Hammer.
Nice.
Thank you, Darvik.
And I will miss horribly.
Yes, hold on 1 second.
At least you had one good deed, right?
Okay, so Flervin is up.
All right, we're going to try another Burning Hands cone if we can here.
All right, one succeeded, one failed. Oh.
Nice.
Moderate damage, so they're hurting.
So I think I'm
okay,
not mistaken.
Yeah, go ahead.
Sorry. I was just going to ask. It's an action to stand up, right?
It's just half your movement, so you can stand up. I'll take off prone.
Okay.
So yeah,
I keep thinking that.
You stand up. That's all right.
Okay. And I'm just going to try and attack him with my short sword, number 10.
Okay. So just
dropping the bow.
Yeah, do I have to say I'm going to drop the bow first? So I want to use both short offhand as well.
Yeah, just so you can drop the bow and pick up one short sword, and the next time you can pick up the other one and attack twice. Because
okay.
it takes an action to drop the bow. Well,
okay.
Sorry, it's not really an action. It's you get one free action, one free interaction with a weapon. So, but attack away.
Did that hit him?
That did. I was looking in chat, so yes, that did.
Sweet. Nice.
And that's solid damage, so stand by 1 second, guys. Urash, thank you for the heal. Let me go in there and redeem it, and I think this will do it. I hope I do these right, and I hope it actually takes it off and does all that stuff. So, Enna, you can take a healing potion... from your inventory, just go to your actions tab and use a healing potion. Urash in chat just gave you a healing potion.
Nice.
Urash, thank you.
Right on.
He was the savior 2 weeks ago, I believe.
That's right, I remember that.
He was. Thanks, Urash.
You did too.
Yeah, just make sure the bugbear is not targeted.
He was.
Hold on, let me put that back on him.
Oops. Did I heal him?
You did. Mm-hmm. But we're good. So I think, and I think you're up, right? Cause it, or was that you that just... No, that was... You just finished, didn't you? Okay, Tamakos.
Thank you again for that.
And Enna, before your next turn, make sure you untarget yourself.
Yes, definitely.
Yeah.
All right, Demakos. Let's see here. Do I focus all the energy on one or try another double attack? Let's see.
This turned out a little bit tougher than I thought it was going to be for these guys. I did buff it up one. And they both succeeded on their saving throws. So they nimbly jump out of the way of the acid.
God, I didn't think they were that dexterous. Alright, that stinks.
Alright, Barbar.
Barbar.
And that's a miss.
Barbar's having a rough day.
Yes, he is.
Alright, Bugbear 10 is going to keep swinging at Enna. Ooh, and he hits. Bugbear 3 is going to keep swinging at Barbar.
Yeah, he deserves it.
And he hits. And resisted, of course, a lot of it. He's going to attack Barbar. Oh, a first crit of the night. Does not trigger the table. Oof. Fortunately, he was raging. Boy. All right, Darby. Wow.
Okay, let's start with a swing from the spiritual weapon.
Oh, good hit. Solid hit. Hey, High Jumper, nice. And guys, let me know if you can't find any of the videos.
Yes.
Very nice.
Yeah, let me know, guys, if I can help at all that. Nice. 10 is dead. So, guys, yeah, let me know if there's anything I can help you with later. Or PM me or text me or PM me, Discord, whatever. But I will definitely help out if I can. This was a good battle to end on. I didn't think it was going to be that tough for us.
Nice. Mace to the face.
Not this time.
Nope. It's a miss.
It was worth a try, though.
It was.
All right, Flirtin.
All right. Third time's a charm. I'm going to use up my last first level spell on Burning Hands. Let's cook these monsters.
Bugbear dirty.
1-1. So, go ahead.
Nice.
And they're hurting, man. Critical, but they are not down.
Not dead yet.
Enna.
Alright.
I need to pick up my bow, so that would be my action?
No, it's just one. You get one interaction, so you can drop your short sword, pick up the bow, and you can still use it, and you can move.
Okay.
Nice.
Alright, Duff. Take care, man. Thanks for coming in. I really appreciate it. Can't wait till I'm playing tomorrow night, and I never play. I've only played in one game so far.
Let them fly.
Literally. One 5e game ever. And it's a miss.
Oh! These little suckers. They must be high in dexterity. Or maybe...
I don't know. We're in armor, too.
All right, Demakos. Yeah, they're wearing some hide armor, and... They're pretty buff.
I think Demakos is just going to do what he does best this time. What the fuck? And not have the right thing selected. There we go. Come on.
And that's a critical hit. And it does not trigger the table, but it's a crit.
Alright. I'm assuming a critical hits.
And he is down.
Woohoo! Which means...
So, High Jumper, before anybody signed off, I wanted to give you guys, at least give you 50 points. I'll probably give you another 50. All right. But I wanted to click on that right away. Thanks for coming
in.
Barbar.
It's time to redeem yourself.
Oh yeah, my god, that'll work. All the crits come at the end of the game.
Yeah.
And he's down.
Suck it.
Nice job, guys. That was a little bit tougher than I thought. That was good. That was a good battle.
Yeah, what? It was tough.
Oh.
Alrighty. Yeah,
giving you XP?
Yes, I was.
She figured out what the floor was made out of.
Maybe it's because he was right next to me.
I've been staring at it for a little while now.
All right. Well, this is going to be a good place to end this. Let me award this. So you guys are at almost 5,800. So you're about 700 experience points away from fifth level.
Nice.
Definitely getting there. So yeah, I think this is a good. I think it's a good stopping point.
Yep.
Yeah, I'll try to think about at least over the weekend updating Realmworks and all that good stuff. But yeah, you guys actually got through quite a bit. This was a good session.
It's a busy one too. Lots of combat.
I know it was, absolutely. Well, cool. It was fun getting back into it, guys. Thanks for joining and stream. Thanks for helping out, Urash. That was cool.
Yeah, thank yes. You. Thank you so much. And I like to pick up my short sword before we
yes.
head out.
And
smart thinking.
And Enna, you kind of think you hear the faint sound of a cat like crying, meowing, like, where has my master gone? Has she forsaken me?
Yeah. So. I like to cut off one of these legs to take with me.
Oh, nice.
Oh my god. Said so sweetly.
Oh my god.
Can I cut off one of these legs?
You oh, man. Your fanny pack.
Yes.
Oh god.
Hold it up there.
Excellent. We'll have to role play that next session. I love that. All right, guys. Well, I'll see everyone in the morning.
All right.
Okay. All right. Thanks, guys. Have a good night.
Bye.
All right. Bye. Oh, that was fun, guys. That was a good time. Let me give you a little more, 50 more gold pieces. If I can get to it. Deep bot, 50. 50 to all. Boom. All right. Anything else I missed in chat? Typically, I dose off here and hit to the Susan. Nice. Nice. I love it. Thanks, High Jumper. Let's see. The only other thing I'm going to pull up for a second, since I'm about to close the stream. I always like to throw this up here, guys. Just kind of shows where you guys all know this, but for people that look in the stream later or catch it on YouTube, I like to put up a slide with the things I use. Obviously, Fantasy Grounds, we all know that. Sirenscape for the one shots, tabletop audio for the sounds, and some of the maps, not tonight, but Zovia. She does hand drawn maps. If you guys were here a couple weeks ago for a roadside encounter, she had an awesome map, so I definitely encourage you to check her out. I support her on Patreon, and yeah, that's it, guys. I really appreciate it. I'm looking forward to the weekend. A lot of games for the President's Day con, so that should be a great time. So, guys, I'm going to sign off, get a little sleep before I have to get up early in the morning, and looking forward to a long weekend of gaming. So thanks again, everybody, for joining, and have a good night.